So hello everybody, welcome back to the platform of An Academy. So yet again another session on pediatric cardiology. So today we are going to finish the rest over parts of cyanotic heart diseases that we could not finish in the last class. So too much of cardiology is also difficult to digest, I understand, and it's very important to understand the concepts in cardiology so that you can bank all the questions and you can solve them rightly in the exam. So any doubts anyone has till now, whatever we have read in cardiology, you can ask me today also. So we can keep discussing any doubts that you people have. And apart from that, today's main topic is to deal with the approach to cyanosis and to diagnose the cyanotic heart diseases. So because we have already discussed all the acyanotic congenital heart diseases, all the obstructive heart diseases, so now we are going to see what happens if the shunt in the heart functions from right towards the left. So if it is from right to left, that means all the dirty blood is going in the left side of the heart. So that is going to mix up and go inside all the body parts, and it will result in what is known as cyanosis. So cyanotic heart disease is not only restricted to TOF, it consists of many disorders which we all should be aware about so that you can answer all these questions confidently in your NEET-PG exam. So till now, whatever we have studied, any doubts that you have, you can keep asking. And after we end up all the cardiology part, we are also going to have a quiz kind of a revision where we will see how can we apply the concepts that we have learned on the MCQ so that you can arrive at the right answer. So any doubts till now, please put it in the chat box. I can re-explain anything that you have not understood till now. So for all of those who are still planning to join an academy or still planning ki kya padhna hai, kaise padhna hai, kahan se padhna hai, so please all of you get hold of one thing that you have to study from an online source of media, which is supposedly the best source to revise and study for your NEET-PG exam, because you get to save a lot of time through the online media, okay? So online media helps you to save a lot of time and effort. This is very, very important for all of you to understand that the amount of time that you invest in your studies and the amount of time that you buy for yourself. Nobody can buy time, definitely, but you have to buy time out of your own schedule. That means you have to plan your schedule and study in such a manner that you can accommodate a lot of revision sessions in your own schedule. So the number of times you revise things, it is going to be very, very useful for you. That is why we always recommend that go for an online media of study so that you get a lot of benefit of saving time and effort. So how do you save time here? It is very important that you don't have to travel here and there for your classes. You can listen to all the classes in a sequence according to your own schedule, according to your own duties, according to your own timing, either live or the recorded version. So that saves a lot of time from your own schedule. So whenever you miss a class, supposedly you cannot listen to the live sessions, you can go back and listen to the recorded version of the class. And whenever there's a marathon or a revision session for that particular class, you can clear all your doubts simultaneously. So if you're still in the process ki kya join karna hai, guys, please go and join the plus subscription. Or we also have a very top-notch subscription, that is the iconic subscription under An Academy. So An Academy is a very huge platform running really well for your NEET-PG preparation. So if you want to get a core foundation preparation for your NEET-PG exam, INICT and FMG exam also, please go and take the plus subscription. So if you take the subscription, you get to access both the live and recorded classes. For your preparation, you get to learn from India's top educators, obviously, because we guys have been screened very, very nicely before taking these classes. You get to compete in live tests and quizzes. So once you compete in the live tests and quizzes, you get an idea about grand tests and you get an idea about how to attempt the questions. ठीक है, सिर्फ थ्योरी पढ़ना इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं होता है. यू शुड बी इन द हैबिट ऑफ अप्लाइंग दिस थ्योरी एंड अप्लाइंग दिस कॉन्सेप्ट्स टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस. सो इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू अप्लाई योर कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस, यू वुड बी एबल टू आंसर एज मेनी क्वेश्चंस एज पॉसिबल इन अ फिक्स्ड ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम. सो अपने आप को कस्टम करना इनटू दैट एनवायरनमेंट ऑफ सॉल्विंग क्वेश्चंस इन दोस 3 आवर्स एंड डूइंग योर बेस्ट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो ऑल ऑफ यू शुड गेट इनटू द हैबिट ऑफ सॉल्विंग दीज एमसीक्यूज, अटेम्प्टिंग अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रैंड टेस्ट, सो दैट व्हेनेवर यू गो फॉर योर मेन एग्जाम, यू फील दैट यू आर जस्ट गोइंग फॉर अनदर ग्रैंड टेस्ट एंड यू कैन परफॉर्म equally as nicely you perform in your grand test. So jaise grand test dete ho, waise waise aapka rank improve hota hai. You get to know the mistakes that you are doing, you tend to improve yourself and you tend to get a better rank again and again after each grand test. So that is how you can approach your own self and you can judge yourself accordingly and you can improvise onto yourself. So competing in life test and quiz is very, very important, because if you do that, you get an idea of your own mistakes and you get to learn from them. Then there's a benefit of attending these classes from any device of your choice. So it's very, very convenient. You can simply log in from your phone, you can use your laptop, you can use any of your devices, maybe an iPad or maybe any tablet. So with that, you can easily access the course and you can listen to these lectures and classes anytime and anywhere. So that is a very huge benefit that we guys have, because we are a part of online media. So you also get to access the question bank with 25,000 plus questions. So what is the benefit over here? Please try to understand the number of questions that you solve, the number of different types of pattern of questions that you get to know. That is going to be the benefit of you to attempt and get a good rank in your exam. Jis tarike ke questions exam mein aate hain, it can keep changing every time. So the pattern of questions keeps on changing every time, but the topics remain the same. So because we all know what are the high yielding topics, we try to focus on those topics as we keep teaching you. So you should know ki haan kaun sa topic kahan se padhna hai, but uske liye concept kaise apply karna hai, questions kaise solve karna hai. So that depends on the pattern of question. So it is very important to expose yourself to clinical questions that has got effective explanations, and you can easily understand that yes, what is the type of question that can be asked this year. So you need to attempt a lot of question. For that you need a good amount of question bank. So please take the plus subscription so that you get the access to these questions and you get to know how to practice them. So those who take a subscription for around 12 months and above will also get a printed set of the handy notes so that you can revise again and again. So you see, so many benefits are there under the same roof of plus subscription. So those who have still not taken, guys, please go and subscribe for your plus subscription. It's going to boost up your preparation really nicely. So we also have the top-notch subscription that I keep telling to take, which is the Iconic subscription. According to me, it is a 5-star subscription that I would say, because it helps you boost your preparation so nicely. It has got two important platforms under the same roof. One is obviously an academy and the other one is the prep ladder. Okay? So do cheeze ek saath combined kyun kiya gaya hai? So you should understand that when you go and take an exam, any exam, competitive exam, the questions are prepared from all globally, or you can say all over the country. So the pattern of question and the mindset by which the question is prepared can be changing every time, but the topics remain the same. So if you have studied something very, very nicely, you will be able to apply your concept and you will be able to solve the questions if you have a clear concept inside your head. But the problem lies that you should be having an idea of what kind of questions can be asked. So attending a subscription which has got two different platforms under itself, you get an exposure to different kind of educators who have made these questions. So you get an idea that you're getting exposed to various kind of patterns or various types of questions that can be created. Similarly, if these kind of questions come in your main exam, then you will be more than glad that you knew these kind of questions and you're able to answer them confidently. It's not first time for you. ठीक है, अगर आपको ऐसा लगता है कि अनअकैडमी में जो हम पढ़ा रहे वही क्वेश्चन आपके क्वेश्चन बैंक में, सो दैट इज नॉट द केस. यस, यू डू गेट अ क्वेश्चन बैंक ऑफ 25,000 प्लस क्वेश्चंस, बट इफ योर कंसेप्ट इज क्लियर, इफ यू हैव स्टडीड फ्रॉम अनअकैडमी, यू कैन टेस्ट योरसेल्फ विद क्वेश्चंस मेड फ्रॉम प्रेप लैडर. You also get a question bank over here, which is going to expose you to so many different patterns of questions. So aapko ye confidence milta hai ki agar aapne topic samajh liya, so you can answer any kind of questions that is framed from that particular topic. So that is why Iconic is so very important to take. If you can, then please do take Iconic subscription. That is something personally also I would recommend. Kyunki jitne questions aap solve karoge, utna aapka confidence badhega, utna practice hoga. That anxiety is going to get cut short every time that you solve different kind of questions. So agar aapne kahin se bhi padhai ki, if your concepts are clear and you are very clear with what you have studied and you are prepared well, you can just attempt taking questions from both the series, and if you solve them nicely, you will get a lot of confidence inside yourself that yes, you can do it. So that is the most important part, to feel positive and to have a good vibe about your own self that yes, you can crack the NEET PG exam. ठीक है, सो दोज हु हैव स्टिल नॉट टेकन, प्लीज गो एंड टेक द आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन. इट गिव्स यू ह्यूज बेनिफिट. अंडर द सेम प्लेटफॉर्म यू गेट ऑल द लाइव क्लासेस टू अटेंड, यू गेट द रिकॉर्डेड क्लासेस टू अटेंड, यू गेट द क्वेश्चन बैंक्स, यू गेट द कॉम्पिटेटिव लाइव टेस्ट एंड क्विजेस, यू गेट द कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव प्रिंटेड एंड डिजिटल नोट्स ऑल्सो. Under the prep ladder course, you get all the integrated classes, you get question banks, rapid revision courses, and you get all the important notes as well. So those who are still planning, please come and join. We are starting so many batches on already started from 11th of August. So we have the Focus FMG batch. So those who are preparing for FMG exam, you can take this course. It helps you again prepare in depth for your FMG exam. We also have the preparation for the next 2022 exam. So those who are thinking that they can attempt the next year's exam, you can come and join this batch, which is again going to extensively prepare you for the next year's exam. Then we have the NEET PG test and analysis batch. So you can analyze yourself on all the 19 subjects, and whatever tests you give a self-analysis of those particular tests, and you get to know that where do you lie in these test series. And we also have an ultra fast track revision of all the high yielding topics for 3 hours every day, so that you finish the marathon revisions well in time and you go very, very confidently for your exam. So that we are also glad that you got a good rank and you also achieve your dream. So fast track revision is a very new concept, very, very important. Before entering the examination hall, it is very important that you have a brief revision of all the high yielding topics. So that is what we offer. So if you take this, you get all the benefits, live classes, integrated approaches, recorded version, PDF of notes, grand tests, and the structured batches for all the exam requirements. So it is a very good platform. Please come and join either the Plus subscription or the Iconic subscription. Now, those who are appearing into this year's exam and have already finished their preparation, we still have a 1 month package for them to take. So under this 1 month package, you can start your fast track revision. You have all the MCQ batches, you have NEET tests and analysis batch. We have previous year papers discussion, COVID test is also there, and grand test series is also there. So those who are still into the phase of having a high yield revision, you can come and join this package. It is very, very useful, and you can attempt your grand test and see where you're still lying, so that whatever number of days are left, you can still improve onto your rank. So the dates have been announced, and as I've already told you that every week you should attempt at least 2 grand tests, and in between these grand tests you should see where you went wrong, what was the reason that you went wrong. Aapko yaad nahi tha, aapne kuch galat pad liya, you were impatient, you could not recall. So jo bhi galtiyan aapne kari apne grand test mein, you should try to improve on those mistakes, so that before 11th of September you are ready for your exam with too much of confidence. So please attempt all the grand tests, and those who are still preparing for this year's exam and have not taken any such subscription, please go and subscribe for the 1 month package. So those who are planning to take the complete subscription, here's a golden opportunity for you. You can take the Genius Med scholarship test. So you get a 50 question of numerical based pattern, which is going to occur on 14th of August at 8 p.m. So all of you can attempt it. It is 1 hour session. Once you attempt it, what is the benefit? You get a chance to win the Plus subscription. If you get rank 1, you get 100% scholarship. If you get rank 2 to 4, you get 75% scholarship. Rank 5 to 9 get 50% scholarship, and 10 to 19 get 25% scholarship. So you can avail all these offers so that you can get your Plus subscription at these subsidized rates because you have got a good rank. So those who are planning to take Unacademy courses, you can also boost up your preparation with the 12 plus 2 package. So under this, you get an additional benefit of accessing your course for extra 2 months. So whatever you have missed, you can easily access, and you can again revise and revise and revise from the same source, which is the key to success. और जिन्हें एम बी बी एस की प्रिपरेशन भी करनी है, सारे प्रॉफ एग्जाम पास करने हैं, साथ में नीट पी जी भी टॉप करना है, सो यू कैन गो फॉर द बेस्ट प्लान दैट वी हैव, द 4 year सब्सक्रिप्शन प्लान. So the cost for 4 year is 60,000 and 75,000 for Plus and Iconic respectively. But if you cut it short to your monthly parts, it's going to be very, very nominal. So please come and take the 4 year subscription plan if you're planning to have a complete foundation course for yourself throughout the 4 years. It's the best plan that you can take. So for those who have been listening patiently, to summarize everything, please come and subscribe for Unacademy so that you get 2 important packages, Plus and Iconic. अगर आपको Plus sufficient लग रहा है, you can take Plus. If you feel you need exposure of 2 important platforms to cross-check yourself and to boost up your preparation all the more, you can also take the Iconic subscription. So at least whenever you take it for 48, 36 or 24 months. ऐसा क्यों है? क्योंकि अगर आप एक ही चीज को बार-बार एक सोर्स से पढ़ते हो, the time period that it takes to revise it the next time is markedly reduced. So you try to save a lot of time, you try to recollect things in a very easy manner, यू फील कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट योर रिविजन एंड यू डू अ लॉट बेटर इन योर मेन एग्जाम. सो जब भी कोई कोर्स लेते हो इतने ड्यूरेशन के ले लो सो दैट यू कैन एक्सेस द कोर्स ईजिली एंड यू आर एबल टू प्रिपेयर वेरी वेरी नाइसली. सो वंस यू डाउनलोड द अनअकैडमी ऐप प्लीज गो टू द परचेज ऑप्शन. फर्स्ट लॉग इन इन टू द नीट पीजी सेक्शन. गो एंड सेलेक्ट द सब्सक्रिप्शन दैट यू वॉन्ट टू टेक. Go to the purchase option and when you go, you only have to put this magical code to get great offers. So please use my code, it is KavitaS10. Once you put down this code, you will get great offers on your subscription plan and the prices will also drop. So you can go and try this. Please take the Plus or the Iconic subscription for a good duration of time so that you can prepare for your exam really, really nicely. Okay, so to begin with today's topic, so all of those who have been attending regularly the pediatric cardiology classes, I hope you are synchronized well with the development of heart, the embryology part, followed by the acyanotic congenital heart diseases, the obstructive heart diseases, and today we'll be doing the cyanotic heart diseases, and the last session we have regarding the acquired heart diseases, which is again a very, very important topic. So any doubts anybody has till now, you can ask me still in the chat box. Till now, if you have listened thoroughly and you're aware of what we have been discussing and the complete theory of pediatric cardiology, you can still ask me if there is any doubt regarding any topic. So we can re-explain anything that you want to in the beginning of the session. So if there is any doubt, you can ask me right away. I'm going to re-explain everything that is required, or else we'll move ahead with the cyanotic heart diseases. Okay, so to begin with the cyanotic part, still for those who are joining, if you have any doubt that that you have in your mind till the topic that we have studied, you can still ask me so that we can keep discussing whatever doubts you have. And also we are going to finish the cyanotic approach today. So we are done with most of the part of cardiology and then we'll be left only with one session dealing with the acquired heart diseases. Okay. So coming on to cyanosis, as we have, if you have attended my session on approach to cyanosis, you would be knowing in detail about what is cyanosis and how do we define it and how do we approach to cyanosis. Okay? So coming on to cyanosis, so basically it is caused because of mixing of the blood. So when oxygenated and the deoxygenated blood mix up, okay, what is going to happen? The saturation levels would fall. So the oxygenation of the blood is compromised, because of which what would happen? It is going to lead to cyanosis. Cyanosis is something that's very simple. It is the bluish discoloration of the skin and the important mucous membrane. You can notice it on the tip of the nose, at the tip of the tongue. You can notice it on ear lobules, on the nail beds. You can examine the oral cavity. You can see all the nails of the patient. So these are the peripheral parts where you can examine cyanosis. So it is the bluish discoloration that occurs because of drop in the oxygen level in the body. So this drop in oxygen level can occur because of either cardiac causes, or it can also occur because of any pulmonary cause. So the pulmonary causes that lead to cyanosis are very huge. The set of list that we have already seen in approach to cyanosis, but the cardiac causes that lead to cyanosis is very, very important to be dealt with. So today we are going to discuss all the important causes out of the cardiac origin that can lead to cyanosis. So in cyanosis, we see there is going to be either increased pulmonary blood flow or there can be decreased pulmonary blood flow. That means if we simply talk about the four chamber view, as I always tell you to revise everything from the four chamber view. Okay, so if we see the four chamber view, this is right atria, right ventricle, left atria and left ventricle. The blood from here goes to the lungs, it gets purified, comes back here, and then from left ventricle it gets pumped out to the whole body. Okay, through the aorta. So this is the normal mechanism that happens in the body. So for cyanosis, what is important? That the blood that is going towards the complete heart, complete body, so that blood from here, from the left ventricle through the aorta, which is moving to the whole body, should be deoxygenated. That means there must have been some kind of mixing through which the deoxygenation is going to occur. So if the deoxygenated blood reaches the left ventricle, the same blood gets pumped out and it moves towards the whole body. out of the aorta. So for mixing to occur in the left ventricle, either the blood from right ventricle can come to left ventricle or the blood from right atria can come to left atria, because of which the deoxygenated blood gets a chance to move into the left ventricle, and from here it gets towards pumped out by the aorta towards the whole body. So that would result in the clinical symptom of cyanosis. So when can this occur? It can only occur when there is some kind of mixing from right towards the left. So first things first, very simple concept to understand. Jab right se left shunting hogi, that means blood hamare right side of the heart se left side of the heart mein, because of any defect it can go. So what will happen? There is going to be deoxygenated. There will be deoxygenation of the blood that is there in the left side of the heart, and the same dirty blood goes into the whole body, resulting into cyanosis. Now, another very important concept here is to know how do we differentiate between these important causes. So to differentiate, we have divided into two important categories, that is decreased pulmonary blood flow and increased pulmonary blood flow. So an increased pulmonary blood flow means that the blood that is going from the right ventricle, that blood is going with a gush. So increased pulmonary blood flow causes are different, and decreased pulmonary blood flow causes are those in which there is some kind of obstruction on the right side of the heart. That means there can be any kind of pulmonary stenosis, or there can be some atresia of the valve, because of which the amount of blood in the right side of the heart is diminished and that blood does not flow freely towards the lungs. So that is what is very, very important while we see the classification of cyanotic heart diseases. So all those diseases which have got increased pulmonary blood flow, what are these conditions? So if there is TGA, that is transposition of great arteries, if there is TAPVR, that is total anomalous pulmonary venous return, or there is truncus arteriosus. So these are the conditions when the whole blood in the right side of the heart is in a gush flow. That means too much of blood is flowing towards the right side of the heart, through which it goes towards the lungs, and it causes increased pulmonary blood flow, and that leads to what is classically known as a plethoric lung field. ठीक है, plethoric lung field का मतलब मैंने बहुत बार समझाया. It just means that the lung field is infiltrated with too much of congestive blood that comes because of the gush of flow from the right side of the heart. So it is a plethora. That means the whole lung field is infiltrated with blood, and that occurs because of too much of blood going from the right side of the heart. Whereas the conditions where there is decreased pulmonary blood flow, it means there is some kind of obstruction in the right side of the heart, because of which this blood ko right atria se right ventricle mein aana tha ya right ventricle se pulmonary vessels mein jana tha, usme koi obstruction ho rahi hai. So because of which the blood is not able to flow out freely. So decreased pulmonary blood flow conditions kahan kahan hote? It is seen in tetralogy of Fallot. It is seen in tricuspid atresia or DOR with PS. So jis bhi condition ya jis option mein aapko pulmonary stenosis dikhta hai, please remember all of these conditions are the result in decreased pulmonary blood flow. So jis option mein bhi aapko pulmonary stenosis ka option dikh raha hai, wo sare options ye hote hain jiska matlab hota hai ki pulmonary blood flow kam hai. Iska matlab kya hoga? X-ray mein aapko oligemic lung fields dikhenge. ठीक है, ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. इट मीन्स दैट वंस यू सी द एक्सरे, वंस यू सी द लंग फील्ड्स, यू वुड नॉट फाइंड एनी काइंड ऑफ इंक्रीज ब्रोंकोवास्कुलर मार्किंग्स, यू विल नॉट फाइंड एनी इंटरस्टिशियल इन्फिल्ट्रेट्स इन द लंग फील्ड. अपेरेंटली द लंग फील्ड इज गोइंग टू लुक वेरी वेरी क्लियर. सो दैट इज वॉट इज नोन एज द ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड. सो दैट इज अ क्लासिकल प्रेजेंटेशन दैट अकर्स बिकॉज ऑफ डिक्रीज्ड पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो. ठीक है, so decreased pulmonary blood flow is something that can be another manifestation of cyanosis. So under these condition you should remember it is TOF, tricuspid atresia, or it can be DORV with pulmonary stenosis. Theek hai, any doubts till now you can keep asking. It is very important to clear your concepts in cardiology. Again and again I keep telling you the same thing, because if you are clear with your concepts you can solve any kind of question that comes in your exam. You can attempt solving questions from any of the MCQ books for your cardiology, and if you have understood whatever is being taught you will be able to solve any kind of question. ठीक है, सो ये सिंपल सी स्लाइड. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ डज साइनोसिस टेक प्लेस इनसाइड द मैकेनिक्स ऑफ द हार्ट, एंड इफ इट इज इंक्रीज ब्लड फ्लो व्हाट कुड बी द कॉज, एंड इफ इट इज डिक्रीज पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो देन व्हाट कुड बी द कॉजेस. So out of cyanosis, one important thing that I would like to again recapitulate over here is the difference between cardiac and pulmonary cyanosis. So we all know that cyanosis is simply the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, because of which what would happen? the SpO2 level is going to decrease. Okay, so SpO2 would fall and there is going to be mixing of the blood. So because of mixing of the blood, kya ho raha hai? The desaturation is going to occur. So this desaturation of blood is going to go inside the whole body of the patient, because of which the patient would turn out to be cyanotic. ठीक है? लेकिन oxygen कम होने का reason क्या है? It can either be cardiac or it can be pulmonary. That means out of cardiac causes there is mixing of blood inside the defect of the heart. That means there is some kind of shunt because of which the blood is getting mixed up. Whereas pulmonary causes are those causes where there are some problem because of which oxygenation of blood is not happening or clearing of the blood is not happening in the pulmonary vessels. So they are different causes which can lead to cyanosis. So it is very important to know how to differentiate between cardiac and pulmonary cyanosis so that you can reach towards the approach to cardiac cyanotic diseases. So there is one doubt, how can we pick up oligemia versus plethora on the radiograph? So once you see the chest x-ray of any of these patients, as we'll be discussing TOF right now, so we'll be seeing all the x-rays. So plethoric lymph field basically has a lot of infiltrates and it has a lot of bronchovascular markings on the chest x-ray. The whole lung field is going to be affected because of the congestion due to the massive blood flow that occurs. And in oligemic lung field, that is classically seen in tetralogy of fellow. So in oligemia, what is going to happen because of the pulmonary stenosis that is present or any component which is obstructing the blood flow from right side of the heart, the chest fields are going to be cleared. So clearing of the chest field occurs because of these obstructions. So you will not find any increased bronchovascular markings or you would not find any kind of infiltrates on the lung field on x-ray. So that is how you can differentiate plethora and oligemia on chest x-ray, and everything is correlated. If you understand the four chamber view for every disease that I have been teaching, and if you understand the mechanics behind it, your ECG finding, your chest x-ray finding, your 2D echo finding, your clinical features, your complication management, everything will get correlated. So please just focus on understanding the topic so that you don't have to mug it up without understanding, and you can still answer everything very nicely in the exam. So cardiac cyanosis and pulmonary cyanosis we have been doing. So if a patient has any cardiac cyanosis, suppose usko koi cardiac lesion hai. So once the patient's RR is calculated, respiratory rate, you will find that cardiac patients do not have too much increase in the respiratory rate. Okay? This is a classical feature of pulmonary cyanosis. So respiratory distress or tachypnea, which we call scientifically, that is going to be seen in cases of pulmonary cyanosis. Okay, there is going to be tachypnea, distress and retractions. So that is classically seen in pulmonary cyanosis. There is going to be too much of respiratory distress and discomfort on breathing. Whereas a cyanotic heart disease patient would not have too much increase in the respiratory rate and is going to be comfortable while breathing. So increase in respiratory rate is never seen in a cyanotic heart disease. It can occur because of superadded infection, but if it is only the cardiac defect that we need to deal with, so that is not going to occur. Okay, so another differentiation point is crying or effort. So if the person starts to cry, I mean the baby starts to cry, because of crying, what will happen? The cyanosis is going to worsen if it is because of cardiac origin. So what happens if we see the four chamber view again? Because the blood is getting shifted from right towards the left. ठीक है, so right to left के वजह से क्या होता है? Cyanosis हो रहा है क्योंकि all the oxygenation is not going to occur properly. The dirty blood is getting mixed up with the clean blood in the left side of the heart. So once the child starts to cry, what happens? The systemic vascular resistance would start to increase. So once the systemic vascular resistance starts to increase, the shunt from right to left is not going to occur effectively. So it is not going to occur effectively. So it can lead to improper shunting of the blood. Now similarly, if the systemic vascular resistance is going to fall, so what will happen? If the resistance is going to fall, so the blood that has to go from the left side of the heart towards the whole body, that is going to go with too much of pressure and too much of speed because the resistance over here has fallen. So the shunting from right towards the left is going to increase. So because of this increase in the shunting, what will happen? Mixing is going to occur more. So if the mixing is going to occur more, so that is going to lead to worsening of the cyanosis in a patient. Whereas in cases of pulmonary cyanosis, what happens if the baby starts to cry? There is going to be good oxygenation. So good oxygenation and good exchange of oxygen in the pulmonary capillaries can occur, because of which the cyanosis can get apparently improved. So crying versus the cyanosis in cases of cardiac origin, and it improves the cyanosis in cases of pulmonary origin. So once you auscultate, definitely you will find a cardiac murmur in cases of cyanotic heart disease. And if it is pulmonary cyanosis, you're going to find crepitations, rails, and wheezing. So these are the classical things that you see in pulmonary cyanotic diseases. If you see the cardiac cellulite on the X-ray, you will see that there is an abnormal shape or there is apparent cardiomegaly on the X-ray. But if you see the pulmonary causes, there will not be any abnormality in the shape of the heart. So if the heart shape is normal, obviously it is pulmonary cause. If the heart shape is abnormal, it is definitely the cardiac cause. If you do an ECG, if you find an abnormal ECG, it is definitely the cardiac cause. And if you do an ECG and you find that it is normal, it can be a pulmonary cyanosis. If you measure the pulmonary CO2 levels, then it can be normal in cardiac cases, and it is usually increased in pulmonary cases because of CO2 retention. So the vessel and the capillaries are not working properly. There is no proper oxygenation. So because of that, what is going to happen? It is going to increase. So PCO2 levels are increased in cases of pulmonary cyanosis. Response to 100% oxygenation. So if you give 100% oxygenation, cardiac cyanosis may not respond very nicely because still the mixing of blood is occurring, right? But if you give 100% oxygenation, the patient with pulmonary cyanosis will show tremendous improvement. This occurs because the whole problem is with the oxygenation, which the pulmonary capillaries are not able to do. So if you supplement them with oxygen, they will show profound improvement. So you should be very clear how to differentiate a cardiac cause from a pulmonary cause. And if you can do that, then you can easily differentiate the causes and the options in the exam also. Okay, any doubts, then please keep asking. Or we'll start with TOF, which is the most important topic in cyanotic heart diseases. Okay, so the link to my Telegram group and everything, I'll explain you in the end. If you have any doubts till now what we have studied, you can ask me. Or I'm going to start with TOF, which is the most important cyanotic heart disease to be done in your curriculum. And you should be clear about the concepts in TOF, the management part and everything. So any doubts till now that you could not understand what is cyanosis, how to differentiate cyanosis, how to approach cyanosis? Any doubts, then please put in the chat box. Okay, so if you have still have any doubts anytime, you can ask me. So starting with TOF, that is tetralogy of Fallot. So basically, TOF is a very important disease because the mechanics is very complicated, but it is very simple to understand. So again, we'll do with a simple four-chamber view. Okay. Okay, so this is the four-chamber view. We have right atria, we have right ventricle, left atria, left ventricle. The blood from right ventricle goes towards the lungs. From here, it gets purified, comes to left atria, then moves to left ventricle, and from aorta, it goes to the whole body. Okay, so TOF mein basically primary defect kya hota hai? So in TOF, what is going to happen? The primary defect is anterior deviation of the infundibular septum. That is the muscular septum that separates the aortic and the pulmonary outflow. So when the heart is getting formed, what is going to happen? There is defect in the anterior deviation of the infundibular septum, the whole septum that separates this aortic part from the pulmonary part. So there are two important trunks in the body. One is the aortic trunk and the other one is the pulmonary trunk. So what is going to happen? When these two are not getting separated properly because of the deviation or the anterior deviation of the infundibular septum, then that is going to lead to the deformity known as tetralogy of Fallot. So because of this, four important things occur. So consequence of this deviation is because of four important components that occur, which is RVOT, that is right ventricular outflow tract obstruction. We have a VST, we have overriding of aorta, and we have RVH. Okay? So right ventricular outflow tract obstruction, ठीक है, यहाँ पे जो obstruction हो गया stenosis के वजह से, so यहाँ से जो भी चीज जानी है वो जानी पाएगी. So right ventricular outflow tract obstruction, अब यहाँ से अगर नहीं जा रही तो कहाँ से जाएगी? यहाँ से जाएगी. कैसे जाएगी? VST बन गया. So यहाँ पे एक ventricular septal defect होता है, ठीक है. Then there is overriding of aorta. overriding of aorta is one component, and because of all the load coming towards the right ventricle back again, so there can be right ventricular hypertrophy. Okay, so this is the classical mechanics that takes place in cases of TOF. So you should be very clear about the four chamber view and what are the components of tetralogy of Fallot. So the degree of pulmonary outflow obstruction determines the degree of cyanosis. So yahan pe cyanosis kyun ho raha hai? क्यों हो रहा है? क्योंकि यहाँ पे जो ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है आपका RVOT का, अगर वो कंप्लीट होगा सो कोई सा ब्लड आपका राइट वेंट्रिकल से पल्मोनरी ट्रैक्ट में नहीं जा पाएगा. सो सारा ब्लड कहाँ जाएगा? शंट के थ्रू लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल में. लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल में कौन सा ब्लड है? ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड, जो लंग से क्लियर होके आया है. अगर यहाँ का डर्टी ब्लड इससे मिक्स हो जाएगा सो व्हाट विल हैपन? लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल चेंबर में ऑल दी ब्लड व्हिच इज डीऑक्सीजनेटेड इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट. सो सारा डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड आपका एओर्टा के थ्रू बॉडी में जाएगा. दैट इज व्हाई टॉफ पेशेंट्स हैव साइनोसिस. ठीक है, सो दिस इज सिंपल कंसेप्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो जितना ज्यादा ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन होगा उतना ज्यादा मिक्सिंग ऑफ ब्लड होगी, उतना ज्यादा पेशेंट के क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स होंगे, एंड दैट मच सिवियर वुड बी द कंडीशन. दैट इज व्हाई वी से इन टॉफ द डिग्री ऑफ पल्मोनरी आउटफ्लो ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन डिटरमिन्स द डिग्री ऑफ पेशेंट साइनोसिस. ठीक है, सो द डिग्री ऑफ पल्मोनरी आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन डिटरमिन्स द डिग्री ऑफ पेशेंट साइनोसिस. The main pulmonary artery may be small and various degree of branch pulmonary artery stenosis may be present. So it's not important that the whole pulmonary artery is stenotic. The main pulmonary artery may be hypoplastic also, and because of this various degree of branch pulmonary artery stenosis can also be present. So apart from this there can be abnormal branching of the blood vessels also in and around the main pulmonary artery. And if there is complete obstruction of right ventricular outflow, that is tetralogy with pulmonary atresia, then it is the most extreme form of TOF. ठीक है, सो अगर कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन हो जाएगा तो क्या होगा? कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन के वजह से द कंप्लीट ब्लड दैट हैज टू गो फ्रॉम द राइट वेंट्रिकल विल नॉट बी एबल टू गो आउट. सो कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ राइट वेंट्रिकुलर आउटफ्लो दैट इज टेट्रोलॉजी ऑफ विद कंप्लीट पल्मोनरी एट्रेसिया वुड बी द मोस्ट एक्सट्रीम फॉर्म ऑफ TOF. So coming to pathogenesis, so very simple to understand. If you understand the cause and the concept, it is very very simple to understand the complete pathophysiology behind it. So any doubts you have anytime, you can keep asking it, because it is very important to understand everything related to pediatric cardiology so that you don't get confused in any of your exams. Okay, so basically what is going to happen over here? The pulmonary valve annulus may range from being nearly normal in size to being severely hypoplastic. So जो हमारा four chamber view है, यहाँ right ventricle से जो हमारा pulmonary trunk जा रहा है, the degree of obstruction is going to be variable. ठीक है, variable क्यों है? क्योंकि अगर यहाँ पे जो obstruction है वो complete है, so none of the blood is going to go from the right side of the heart. It can be completely normal, it can have a dynamic obstruction, or it can be completely abnormal, that is severely hypoplastic. Okay, so the amount of obstruction is very very important to determine the kind of cyanosis that the patient would have. So the valve is often bicuspid or unicuspid and is the only site of stenosis. That is because of the abnormality in this pulmonary area, the patient is going to have a features of cyanosis. Subpulmonic or infundibular muscle, which is known as crista supraventricularis, gets hypertrophic, which contributes to the subvalvular stenosis. So agar yahan hamara pulmonary stenosis yahan pe ho gaya, which muscle is involved because of the stenosis and because of the hypertrophy? So cyanotic spells will start once the patient starts to have problem with increased pressure, that would lead to pulmonary stenosis getting increased. So since we are discussing the amount of cyanosis, jitna bhi cyanosis patient mein hota hai, that all depends on the degree of obstruction that is present in the RVOT, that is right outflow tract obstruction. Abhi obstruction kitna hoga wo determine hota hai aapke stenosis ke level pe. Either there is anatomical abnormality or it can also have a dynamic abnormality. So whenever catecholamines are released in the body, many a times what happens, it is going to go and act on the valve receptors also, because of which the stenosis is going to get increased. So as and when the stenosis will increase, there is going to be more shunting of blood from right to left, kyunki us area se blood bahar nahi ja payega from the pulmonary trunk. So right and left shunting would increase and the patient is going to have cyanotic spell. So we will deal with that in after few slides again, but to clear your doubt over here, so that is how cyanotic spell occurs. सो हमारा क्रिस्टा सुप्रा वेंट्रिकुलरिस मसल होता है जिसकी हाइपरट्रॉफी हो जाती है. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हाइपरट्रॉफी इट विल लीड टू सब वेल्वुलर स्टेनोसिस. सो हमारा पल्मोनरी वॉल्व होता है यहाँ पे, उसके नीचे हाइपरट्रॉफी के वजह से देर इज गोइंग टू बी सब वेल्वुलर स्टेनोसिस. सो व्हेन द राइट वेंट्रिकुलर आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट इज कम्प्लीटली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड और पल्मोनरी एट्रेजिया इज देयर, कम्प्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज देयर, देन द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द ब्रांच पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज इज एक्सट्रीमली वेरिएबल. सो क्योंकि कम्प्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है यहाँ पे, सो देर आर मेनी मेनी ब्रांच पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज दैट बिगिन टू डेवलप. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दीज ब्रांच पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ वेरिएबिलिटी इन द एनाटॉमी ऑफ पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. सो द मेन पल्मोनरी आर्टरी मे बी इन कंटिन्यूटी विद द आरबीओटी और इट कैन ऑल्सो भी सेपरेटेड बाय अ फाइब्रस पल्मोनरी वॉल और सिवियरली हाइपोप्लास्टिक और मे बी कम्प्लीटली एबसेंट. सो यू अंडरस्टैंड जो हमारा पल्मोनरी वॉल्व होता है वहां पे राइट वेंट्रिकुलर आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट है, राइट. सो ये राइट वेंट्रिकुलर आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट का जो रिस्पॉन्स होता है दैट इज टोटली डिपेंडेंट ऑन द अमाउंट ऑफ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन दैट इज प्रेजेंट. या तो इसमें कोई एनाटॉमिकल डिफेक्ट होगी या फिर इट कैन बी अ सिंपल स्टेनोसिस व्हिच इज अफेक्टेड बाय सम डायनामिक कंपोनेंट. सो इफ द एनाटॉमिकल डिफेक्ट इज देयर इट कैन बी कम्प्लीटली नॉर्मल, इट कैन बी पार्शियली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड, इट कैन बी कम्प्लीटली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड. सो इफ द मेन पल्मोनरी आर्टरी इज कम्प्लीटली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड दैट मीन्स द वॉल्व इज कम्प्लीटली हाइपोप्लास्टिक और एबसेंट, सो वॉट विल हैपन, द कम्प्लीट ट्रैक्ट गेट्स ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड. सो इट इज द मोस्ट एक्सट्रीम फॉर्म ऑफ टॉफ बिकॉज नन ऑफ द ब्लड इज एबल टू फ्लो फ्रॉम देयर टुवर्ड्स द पल्मोनरी ट्रैक्ट, ठीक है. बट इफ द ओनली द मसल विच इज प्रेजेंट दैट इज द इनफेंडिबुलर मसल that is present known as crestae supraventricularis, if that gets hypertrophied which contributes towards the subvalvular stenosis, so that is going to lead to only subpulmonic or subvalvular stenosis because only a part of this muscle is hypertrophied and it is going to lead to stenosis only when this abnormal flow of the blood or obstruction to the blood flow from the right ventricle. So that is how it is a dynamic component. Jitna zyada stenosis hoga, utna zyada cyanosis hoga. So depending on the amount of stenosis that is going to take place, the patient's clinical presentation can vary. सो ब्रांच पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज क्यों बन रहे थे, क्योंकि कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन हो रही थी. सो पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो में बी सप्लाइड बाय द पेटेंट डक्टस और देयर कैन बी मल्टीपल अयोटो पल्मोनरी कोलेट्रल आर्टरीज. सो जो हमारा ये ट्रंक है पल्मोनरी और ये अयोटिक ट्रंक है, सो इन बिटवीन देयर कैन बी मेनी कनेक्शंस नोन एज मल्टीपल अयोटो पल्मोनरी कोलेट्रल आर्टरीज और MAPCAs. सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन वी डू अ सर्जिकल करेक्शन ऑफ अ टॉफ पेशेंट. तो सर्जिकल करेक्शन के लिए MAPCAs बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं. सो दे आर फॉर्म बिकॉज ऑफ द कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन टू द पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो सो दैट दे कैन गिव अ लॉट ऑफ ब्लड सप्लाई. सो देर आर मल्टीपल कनेक्शंस बिटवीन द अयोटो एंड पल्मोनरी कोलैटरल आर्टरीज व्हिच रिजल्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ पिक्चर. सो VST जो व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट सो दैट द ब्लड मूव्स फ्रॉम द राइट साइड ऑफ द हार्ट टू द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द हार्ट, दिस इज यूजुअली नॉन रिस्ट्रिक्टिव एंड लार्ज एंड इट इज सब अयोटिक टाइप, ठीक है. सब अयोटिक कहने का मतलब इट्स लोकेशन, सो इट इज लोकेशन लोकेटेड सब अयोटिक एंड इट इज यूजुअली नॉन रिस्ट्रिक्टिव एंड इट इज लार्ज. व्हाई इट इज लार्ज, बिकॉज सो मच ऑफ ब्लड हैज टू फ्लो फ्रॉम राइट टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट. सो द अयोटिक आर्च इज यूजुअली राइट साइडेड इन 20% ऑफ द केसेस. देयर इज ओवरराइडिंग ऑफ अयोटा and the aortic arch becomes right-sided in 20% of the cases. The systemic venous return to right atria and right ventricle is absolutely normal. So there is no problem in the right atria and right ventricular part क्योंकि जो भी blood गया आपके left ventricle में गया, वहाँ से body में गया. But the blood which has to go to the lungs and come from here, that path is absolutely normal. So जो right atria और right ventricle का venous return होता है, वो बिल्कुल normal होता है. When right ventricle contracts in the presence of marked pulmonary stenosis, the blood gets shunted from the VST into the left side of the heart and this results in cyanosis. And the amount of cyanosis that is going to occur depends upon the amount of obstruction that is there. So, jitna obstruction hoga, utna blood aapka right se left mein shunt ho jayega. So, peak pressure in each ventricle are similar and at systemic levels. Okay? So degree of RVOT obstruction determines the timing of the onset of symptoms and the degree of RVH. So it is very very important. The only key concept that you should know, it is right ventricular outflow tract obstruction which determines that how much is the symptom that is going to occur, how much is the severity of the cyanosis that is going to occur and what is the degree of right ventricular hypertrophy that is going to occur. So right ventricle hypertrophy kyun ho rahi hai? Kyunki sara blood aapka right ventricle mein hi reh raha hai. Kyunki outflow tract mein there is obstruction. ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सो जितना ज्यादा ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन होगा उतना ब्लड राइट वेंट्रिकल में अक्यूमुलेट होगा, उतना ही ब्लड VST के थ्रू राइट वेंट्रिकल से लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल में शिफ्ट होगा. जितना ज्यादा ब्लड शिफ्ट होगा उतना डीऑक्सीजनेशन होगा और उतना ही पेशेंट को साइनोसिस होगा. सो दैट इज हाउ यू कैन कोरिलेट एवरीथिंग. सो द मैकेनिक्स फॉर टेट्रोलॉजी ऑफ फैलो इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू शुड बी वेरी क्लियर विद द फोर चेंबर व्यू. सो यू कैन आस्क एनी डाउट्स दैट यू हैव एंड इफ यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग यू कैन लीव अ थम्स अप ऑल्सो एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट एनीथिंग टू बी रिपीटेड यू कैन आस्क दैट. So when the obstruction to the right ventricular outflow tract is mild to moderate and there is a balanced shunt which is present across the VST, the patient might not be visibly cyanosed. इसको हम कहते हैं pink TOF. ठीक है, TOF के सारे features इसमें भी present होते हैं. बस difference क्या होता है, जो obstruction के बारे में हम तब से पढ़ रहे हैं that right ventricular outflow tract obstruction is the most important factor. So if this obstruction is very very mild then what will happen, there's going to be a balanced shunt. That means VST के through इतना सारा blood आपका left में नहीं जाएगा. So because the obstruction is not very severe, so blood is also going towards the pulmonary trunk. So if the blood is flowing from both the parts, it is not going to result in severe cyanosis. So that is why these kind of patients are known as pink TOF. So when obstruction is severe, cyanosis will present from birth and worsen when the ductus arteriosus begins to close. ठीक है, सो इफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज सिवियर देन वट विल हैपन, द साइनोसिस कैन प्रेजेंट राइट एट बर्थ बिकॉज देर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी एनी अदर ऑल्टरनेटिव पाथवे फ्रॉम विच द ब्लड कैन फ्लो आउटसाइड द पल्मोनरी ट्रंक बिकॉज इट इज कम्प्लीटली ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड. सो दे कैन प्रेजेंट एट बर्थ. दैट्स वाई वी गेट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इन योर एग्जाम, कैन TOF be presented at birth? Yes, it can be presented at birth only in cases where the RVOT is completely obstructed. That means the right ventricular outflow tract is completely obstructed and because of which what is going to happen, the blood is not able to flow properly from the right ventricular outflow tract. So any doubts in the mechanism of TOF that you are not able to understand, you can ask me, and if you are able to understand, you can leave a thumbs up so that I can keep moving ahead. The pressure in both the ventricles would be same when the shunting is occurring. Okay, so moving on to the clinical features. Now, infants who have got mild degree of RVOT obstruction can initially present only with heart failure because they have a VST that leads to left to right shunt. Okay, जिसमें obstruction बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं है उसमें क्या होगा? जो आपका right side का heart है वहां से ब्लड लंग्स में भी जा रहा है और वीएसटी के थ्रू थोड़ा बहुत ब्लड राइट से लेफ्ट में जा रहा है. सो इट विल बिहेव लाइक अ नॉर्मल वीएसटी, नॉट एज अ कंप्लीट साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज. सो वीएसटी पेशेंट्स प्रेजेंट हाउ? दे प्रेजेंट विद फेलियर ऑफ हार्ट. सो द फेलियर ऑफ हार्ट इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट एज इट इज सीन इन नॉर्मल वीएसटी पेशेंट्स इफ द माइल्ड डिग्री ऑफ आरवीओटी इज प्रेजेंट. बट इफ द आरवीओटी इज सिवियर देन व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल रिजल्ट इनटू साइनोसिस. सो ऑफन साइनोसिस इज नॉट प्रेजेंट नॉर्मली एट बर्थ एंड इट अकर्स ओनली इन first year of life. But please mark the statement, it mentions often cyanosis is not present normally at birth. But if you get a question, can cyanosis be present at birth in TOF? The answer is yes, it can be present because if the RVOT is completely obstructed, then what will happen? The blood flow will not move from the right ventricular outflow tract because of which shunting is going to increase and cyanosis will occur immediately at birth also. So it's a very huge misconception that TOF never presents at birth, but it can present at birth. Only those cases jisme severe RVOT hai. Okay? So please clear this doubt inside your head. No, never ever have a misconception about this point. So cyanosis normally does not occur at birth kyunki ye first year of life tak hi aata hai. But neonatal cyanosis is seen in severe degree of RVOT obstruction where the pulmonary blood flow is totally dependent on the ductus arteriosus. So agar pulmonary blood flow ke paas koi option hi nahi hoga aage jaane ka, so what will happen? It will get shunted. Once it gets shunted, there is mixing of blood and cyanosis is very very evident. Therefore when ductus closes in few hours of life, what will happen? Cyanosis can worsen and the baby can collapse also. Heart failure in TOF does not occur usually. It can only occur when there is very very mild degree of RVOT. So if the RVOT is very very mild, then what will happen? The blood can flow from the right side towards the lungs also. So jo VST hamara component hai TOF ka, uske wajah se right to left shunt hoga. So is right to left shunt ke wajah se at times you can have features of cardiac failure. But if you are asked that cardiac failure occurs frequently in TOF, it does not occur frequently in TOF. It only occurs in few cases where there is very very mild degree of obstruction of the right ventricular outflow tract. Okay, So older children who have proper tetralogy of Fallot, they start to develop dark blue or gray sclera, engorged blood vessels, and there is marked clubbing of the hands and feet. All of this occurs because of the cyanosis. ठीक है, सो जितना ज्यादा प्रोफाउंड साइनोसिस साइनोसिस होगा और जितना लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग साइनोसिस होगा उतने ज्यादा सिम्टम्स पेशेंट में आने शुरू हो जाएंगे. सो ओल्डर चिल्ड्रन हु हैव साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज, दे प्रेजेंट विद डार्क और ब्लू कलर्ड स्किन विद ग्रे स्क्लेरा, एनगॉस्ड ब्लड वेसल्स एंड दे हैव मार्क्ड क्लबिंग ऑल्सो. ठीक है, क्लियर है क्लिनिकल फीचर्स? एनी डाउट्स प्लीज कीप आस्किंग. So the patient can also have dyspnea on exertion, which is present, that causes the stopping of physical activity, and the child has to sit or lie down, and this is what we call characteristically a squatting position. So, जब भी कोई बच्चा physical activity करता है, what is going to happen? The oxygen demand in the body increases. So, because of this oxygen demand, what is going to happen? The blood shunting is increased from right to left. So right to left shunting से increase होने से क्या होगा? Cyanosis तो और increase हो जाएगा. So cyanosis increase होने के वजह से the child becomes more desaturated and he sits in a squatting position. That's why you always get the word in the question, squatting is common. So squatting is common in a patient who has got cyanotic heart disease, especially TOF, and is able to resume the physical activity after few minutes of squatting. So ऐसे क्यों होता है? Exercises induce cyanosis because the physical demand of the body increases. There is increased amount of oxygenation that is required. So because of this oxygenation, the pump, the action of the heart is going to increase. And once the left side of the heart is going to pump out more blood, the blood from right towards the left is also going to increase. So the shunt would increase, because of which what will happen? More mixing of blood is going to happen. And because of more mixing of blood, what will happen? The patient is going to turn cyanotic. To relieve this cyanosis, the child goes into a squatting position. So squatting se kya benefit milta hai? Squatting se the femoral vessels जो होते हैं हमारे, दैट गेट्स कंप्रेस्ड. सो वंस इट गेट्स कंप्रेस्ड, योर सिस्टमिक वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस. सो इफ योर सिस्टमिक वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस, द होल प्रेशर गोज फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट हार्ट. सो अगर लेफ्ट हार्ट के आउटलेट पे प्रेशर इंक्रीज हो जाएगा, सो जिस ब्लड को लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द हार्ट से बाहर आना था, दैट ब्लड इज नॉट गोइंग टू कम आउट इजिली. सो दिस फ्लो गेट्स रिवर्स्ड. सो जो राइट से लेफ्ट का शंट चल रहा है, जिसके वजह से मिक्सिंग हो रही है, वो डिक्रीज हो जाती है. सो द शंटिंग इज डिक्रीज फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द इंक्रीज इन सिस्टमिक वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस ड्यू टू स्क्वाटिंग. इसलिए स्क्वाटिंग करने के बाद क्या होता है? द पेशेंट इज रिलीव्ड ऑफ साइनोसिस बिकॉज द राइट टू लेफ्ट शंट वॉज डिक्रीज. ठीक है, बट इट इज टेम्पररी. वंस द स्क्वाटिंग इज ओवर, अगेन द शंटिंग कैन अकर एंड द पेशेंट कैन अगेन डेवलप साइनोसिस. ठीक है, so another very important clinical feature that we have in TOF is paroxysmal hypercyanotic attack, जिसको हम blue tet या tet spells कहते हैं, which is the problem that occurs in the first 2 years of life. ठीक है, इसमें क्या होता है? The child suddenly becomes hyperdypnic, the child can have restlessness, the child can become cyanotic, can have Caspian respiration and can have syncope also. जो ये spells होते हैं, cyanotic spells, they occur because of sudden RVOT obstruction. ठीक है, right outflow tract जो होती है उसकी obstruction बहुत ज्यादा profound हो जाती है, then the patient presents with cyanosis. So when can this become profound? It occurs because of extreme crying episodes, vigorous crying episodes, or very too much of exercise induced. But in the initial 2 years, exercise induced is not a very common thing, because initial 2 years but there's not too much of physical activity. So when the babies cry extensively, what is going to happen? Because of this vigorous crying, it can result into cyanotic spell. So it occurs more commonly when? It occurs more commonly during the morning hours. And this is a hypothesis. It is said that the babies wake up and once they don't see their mothers around, so they start to cry, and that is the reason why we call it, it occurs during morning hours after awakening or after a vigorous cry. Okay? So there can be temporary disappearance of the murmur also, once the blood flow across the right ventricle has decreased. So because of this extreme crying episode, what happens? It increases the amount of stenosis that is present in the right ventricular outflow tract. ठीक है, जैसे जैसे स्टेनोसिस इंक्रीज होगा, क्या होगा? जिस ब्लड को पल्मोनरी ट्रंक के थ्रू बाहर जाना था, वो नहीं जा पाएगी. सो ब्लड विल गेट अकोमोडेटेड इन द राइट वेंट्रिकल. राइट वेंट्रिकल के पास क्या है? उसके पास VST है. वो क्या करेगा? राइट वेंट्रिकल वेंट्रिकुलर सेप्टल डिफेक्ट के थ्रू अपना सारा ब्लड लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल को दे देगा. लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल क्या करेगा? इट इज गोइंग टू कॉज मिक्सिंग ऑफ द ब्लड, डर्टी ब्लड विद द फ्रेश ब्लड दैट इट इज गेटिंग फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एट्रिया दैट हैज कम फ्रॉम द लंग्स. सो मिक्सिंग ऑफ द ब्लड करने के बाद लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल विल पंप आउट ऑल द ब्लड blood in the whole body, because of which the child will get cyanosis. Okay. So spells are very common in the early morning hours because of vigorous crying episodes. Okay. So there can be temporary disappearance of the murmur as the flow across the right ventricle diminishes. So as the flow towards the right ventricle is going to decrease, the murmur is also going to decrease. The short episodes are followed by generalized weakness. There can be severe spells also, after which the baby can go unconscious. Okay. If there's sudden drop in the saturation level, then what can happen? The baby can also become unconscious, and because of this, certain complications can also occur, that is seizure. Okay, and hemiparesis. So these are all the complications that can occur after the cyanotic spell. So association with reduction in already compromised pulmonary blood flow, causing severe systemic hypoxia and metabolic acidosis. So if the oxygen level is too much compromised because of very much increase in the shunt of right to left and too much increase in cyanosis, what will happen? The baby will go into hypoxia and metabolic acidosis, because of which the child can even have unconsciousness. So infants who are mildly cyanotic at rest are prone to develop hypoxic spells because they do not have the acquired balance to tolerate rapid lowering of arterial oxygen, such as polycythemia. So there are many a times that you see that those who are mildly cyanotic at rest, they are more prone to develop hypoxic spell because their body is not trained enough to tolerate rapid lowering of the arterial oxygen saturation. So that is why in TOF patients, polycythemia is a protective thing, and we keep the hemoglobin of these patients on a higher side because polycythemia is going to be protective for the patients of TOF. So it is very important to keep their hemoglobin at least above 10 so that they don't go into cyanotic spells, because those who are mildly cyanotic at rest and those who are not prone to adjusting towards sudden lowering of the oxygen saturation, whenever they have a situation in which the SpO2 is going to fall, so these patients will suddenly land up into cyanotic spell. So it is very, very important to maintain a good hemoglobin level for these patients so that they do not have cyanotic spell. So more than equal to 10 at least should be the target for hemoglobin in a case of cyanotic spell. Cardiomegaly is not seen in tetralogy of Fallot. That is not an important clinical finding. You only get right ventricular hypertrophy, and oxygenation improves cyanosis over here. That is because this SpO2 has fallen off suddenly because of the obstruction of the blood flow towards the pulmonary trunk. So oxygen is definitely going to improve. But even if you have a feature where you have to differentiate between the oxygenation point, it is not the complete reversal thing, because only oxygenation will not improve the cyanotic spell. You have to reverse the shunt that has occurred from right to left. So for that, we need to give IV medications like beta blockers and those drugs which can increase the systemic vascular resistance. So just as the systemic vascular resistance increase hoga, the amount of shunt that is occurring from the right towards the left is going to decrease. So once the shunt decreases, what is going to happen? The mixing of blood will be prevented and the cyanosis will decrease. So that is how we treat a cyanotic spell. So coming on to mechanism of hypoxic spell. So hypercyanotic episodes or spells in the patients with tetralogy are of uncertain origin, but as I told you, it is said excessive crying can stimulate the catecholamine release in the body, which goes and acts on the valve, and it can sometimes lead to increased stenosis. So that is one important hypothesis that is there regarding the onset of cyanotic spell. It is likely that some episodes are caused because of unusual hyperactivity of the muscular fibers in the right and ventricular outflow tract, and it produces an exaggerated infundibular stenosis, which increases the pulmonary resistance and therefore increase the right to left shunt. Okay? Whatever I have taught you, the same thing as written in such a huge statement, that whenever the muscle part or the right ventricular outflow tract is going to increase. Agar ye increase ho jayega to kya hoga? Because of hyperactivity of these muscles, the right ventricular outflow tract can get more and more obstructed. So if it will get obstructed, what will happen? Jis blood ko yahan se nikal ke aage jana tha, wo blood aage nahi ja payega. So because of this, the blood is going to get again accommodated in the right ventricle. So right ventricle se ye kahan jayega? Through the VST, it will go to the left ventricle. So left ventricle mixing will occur and the whole blood will again move towards the body, because of which what can happen? Again, cyanosis will take place. So this vicious cycle of hypoxic spell keeps on occurring. There's a decrease in the arterial PO2 levels, which stimulates the respiratory center, and the hyperventilation results. So if the patient is going to increase the hyperventilation, hyperapnea increases the systemic venous return also. So in the presence of right ventricular outflow tract, the increased systemic venous return results in increasing left to right to left shunt and therefore worsening of the cyanosis. So as the baby is going to keep on crying, so what will happen? The respiratory center gets stimulated, hyperventilation is going to occur. Systemic venous return is going to increase. Systemic venous return should increase, but if there is right ventricular outflow tract obstruction, what will happen? The increased systemic venous return can result into increase in the right to left shunt. So jitne baar right to left shunt aapka increase hoga, utni zyada mixing of blood hogi and it can worsen the cyanosis. So that is why it is very important to control the cyanotic spell by medical management. So once you see the management of TET spells, what we have to do? We have to see that it is characterized by what features, whether it is caused because of hyperapnea, that is deep respiration, it is irritability and prolonged cry, it can lead to increased cyanosis, and because of severity, it can also have decreased intensity of the heart murmur. Intensity kyun kam ho gayi? Kyunki aapka blood flow decrease ho gaya us area se. Because of the increase in the obstruction, the blood flow has decreased. So that is why the amount of murmur that we see here in a normal TOF patient, that much intensity of murmur would not be appreciated when the patient is having a cyanotic spell. So hypoxic spell can occur in infants with a peak incidence between 2 to 4 months of age. These spells usually occur in the morning after crying, feeding and defecation. A severe spell can lead to convulsions also and cerebrovascular accidents. It can lead to unconsciousness due to sudden drop in the oxygen level, and it can also lead to death of the child if gone unnoticed. So it is very, very important to know how to manage a cyanotic spell because it is a treatable condition and it can be easily treated and prevented. Okay. Hypoxia and hemoglobin has the relation related to polycythemia basically. So if these patients have polycythemia, that means the hemoglobin is on the higher side, more than at least 10, then they are used to tolerating the sudden fall in oxygen. The sudden fall in oxygen is very, very important to be tolerated so that they don't go into recurrent episodes of spell. So if they are used to having a good amount of hemoglobin in the body, they are polycythemic. So that is going to tolerate the desaturation episodes. But those who are mildly cyanotic and those who do not have polycythemia, so what is going to happen? That in those cases, they will have recurrent episodes of hypoxic or cyanotic spells because of which the complication rate can also occur. Okay, so that is very important to understand. So these are all the complications that can occur in a case of cyanotic spell. So coming on to the treatment, so very important part, must know topic and a must know MCQ for you. So treatment of hypoxic spell is basically you have to break this vicious cycle of crying episode leading to cyanosis and increasing the respiratory drive and leading to cyanotic spell. So this is very important to understand. Sabse pehle kya karna hota hai? You are doing a pediatric emergency and somebody comes and tell you that the baby is having a cyanotic spell. So what would you do? So you have to first start the management with the person who has come and told you that the baby is having cyanotic spell. You have to scold the person and you have to tell them that he should be standing on the bedside and you should have put the baby in a knee chest position instantly. Okay? So even before giving oxygen and even before explaining anything to anybody, just hold the child into a knee chest position. Okay? So knee chest position se kya hota hai? Again, the return is going to increase. Because of this, the right to left ventricle shunting would decrease. Okay? Jaise se hum shunt ko kam karenge, waise waise kya hota hai? The amount of mixing of the blood is going to decrease. So agar hum SVR body mein increase kar denge, systemic venous return ko agar increase kar denge, ठीक है, the pressure of systemic venous pressure को अगर हम increase कर देंगे, so क्या होगा, हमारा shunt जो right से left के तरफ हो रहा था, उस चीज को हम reverse कर सकते हैं. So अगर हमने shunt को reverse कर दिया, तो mixing of blood नहीं होगा. अगर mixing of blood नहीं होगा, तो cyanosis would improve. So first things first, you have to scold the person who came running to you and tell him to go and hold the baby in knee chest position. After that, once you arrive at the bed of the patient, you have to put a high flow oxygen. So this oxygen is given only to improve the sudden fall in oxygen level, that is desaturation ko control karne ke liye hum oxygen lagate, but it will not reverse the process of cyanotic spell. It is only a supportive treatment over here. उसके बाद हमें मॉर्फिन देना है. वी गिव इट एट द डोज ऑफ 0.1 to 0.2 mg/kg. यू कैन गिव इट साइमल्टेन सबक्यूटेनियसली ऑल्सो एंड इंट्रामस्कुलरली ऑल्सो एंड ऑल्सो आईवी. So this is given why? So that the respiratory center is suppressed and this vicious cycle of having respiratory distress, hyperventilation, hyperapnea is getting controlled. So morphine हम इसलिए देते हैं. Then we have to also give correction of acidosis. So we have to give soda bicarb at the dose of 1 mEq/kg over 20 to 30 minutes. इसका भी effect क्या होता है? It reduces the respiratory center stimulating effects of the acidosis. So this is very, very important. You need to give a correction of soda bicarb. Now beta blockers are used so that it can reverse the stenosis that has taken place. So we give beta blockers at the dose of 0.01 mg/kg, which can be metoprolol or propranolol, which is given by slow IV method so that it can reverse the spell that has occurred in the patient. If the hypoxic spell do not respond to all these usual treatment that we do, that is your oxygen, morphine and a beta blocker and soda bicarb correction, then what you can try ketamine, because this also increases your systemic vascular resistance. So because of this increase, what will happen? Again, the shunt that was occurring from right to left would get reversed. So jaise shunt reverse hoga, kya hoga? Mixing of the blood kam ho jayegi. Mixing of the blood kam hone ke wajah se, what is going to happen? The cyanosis is going to decrease. So ketamine you can give from 1 to 3 mg/kg, which is administered IV route over 1 minute. If you want further drugs which can increase systemic vascular resistance, then you can sedate the infant. You can also put the baby on phenylephrine effusion. So phenylephrine infusion is also very important drug which can be used at the dose of 0.01 to 0.02 mg/kg IV. So these are vasoconstrictors. They again increase your systemic vascular resistance. Just as the resistance increase over, shunting from right towards the left is also going to decrease. So this is how you manage a case of cyanotic spell, which is very, very important. So if the baby is not having spell and is growing ahead in life, so what will happen? Because of persistence decrease in oxygen and cyanosis, the child will have certain complications also. So the pubertal growth is very much delayed because of chronically desaturation of less than 70% that is there. And the pulse is usually normal in these patients. If you examine, there is not going to be apparent cardiomegaly. There is no cardiac compromise as such. Left anterior hemithorax may bulge out because of long-standing right ventricular hypertrophy. So once you examine the chest, you can see there's a bulging out of the hemithorax because of right ventricular hypertrophy. Substernal right ventricular impulse can be present, so you can palpate it in this area because of the hypertrophy. There is systolic thrill which may be found in the left sternal border in the third and fourth parasternal spaces. So this is again palpable because of the enlargement of the heart that has occurred. There's a classical systolic murmur which is loud and harsh. It is transmitted widely and best heard at again the left sternal border. ठीक है, लेफ्ट लोअर स्टर्नल बॉर्डर यू शुड रिमेंबर, दिस इज द बेस्ट प्लेस वेयर यू कैन अप्रिशिएट द मर्मर. इट इज जनरली द इजेक्शन सिस्टोलिक टाइप एट द अपर स्टर्नल बॉर्डर, बट इट कैन बी होलो सिस्टोलिक एट द लोअर स्टर्नल बॉर्डर. सो यू हैव अ कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ VST ऑल्सो, सो यू शुड नो दैट दिस कॉम्पोनेंट ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स टूवर्ड्स द होलो सिस्टोलिक मर्मर. So the murmur is produced basically when the blood flows because of turbulence through the RVOT. It tends to be louder or larger and harsher as the severity of pulmonary stenosis increases. So the more the gush of blood that is going towards the RVOT, the more is the murmur that is going to be produced. So murmur becomes less prominent during the hypercyanotic spells. स्पेल के टाइम पे क्या होता है? स्टेनोसिस बहुत ज्यादा इंक्रीज हो जाता है. देयर इज बेयरली एनी ब्लड दैट कैन फ्लो एज अ गश ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रैक्ट. सो दैट इज व्हाई द मर्मर बिकम्स साइलेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ हाइपरसाइनोटिक स्पेल्स. सो वंस यू एग्जामिन द S2, सो व्हाट विल हैपन? बिकॉज द पल्मोनरी पार्ट इज कॉम्प्रोमाइज, सो द पल्मोनरी कॉम्पोनेंट इज गोइंग टू बी सॉफ्ट एंड यू कैन हियर अ सिंगल सेकेंड हार्ट साउंड. And continuous murmur कब मिलता है टॉफ में? Very important question. टॉफ में continuous murmur can be present if there are too many collaterals that has formed in your aortopulmonary component. So to overcome the obstruction of the pulmonary artery, if too many collaterals have been formed, then you can also get a classical continuous murmur. So coming to the diagnosis, clinically आपने देख लिया कि टॉफ में क्या होता है, कैसा दिखता है. अब हमें डायग्नोज करना है, तो हम चेस्ट एक्सरे करेंगे, ECG करेंगे, 2D एको करके देखेंगे. सो चेस्ट एक्सरे में हमें क्या मिलता है? यू फाइंड अ नैरो बेस ऑफ द हार्ट विद कॉन्केविटी ऑफ द लेफ्ट हार्ट बॉर्डर इन द एरिया दैट वॉज यूजली ऑक्यूपाइड बाई द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. बट प्लीज रिमेम्बर द साइज ऑफ द हार्ट इज ऑलवेज नॉर्मल. ठीक है, सो हाइपरट्रॉफी ऑफ द राइट वेंट्रिकल ओनली अकर्स बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हाइपरट्रॉफी. इट गेट्स लिफ्टेड अप ऑन द चेस्ट एक्सरे. इट कॉजेज अ राउंडेड एपाइकल शेडो टू बी अपलिफ्टेड सो दैट इट इज सिचुएटेड हाई अबव द डायफ्राम देन द नॉर्मल एंड इट पॉइंट्स टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट चेस्ट वॉल. So this classical finding that results in the boat-shaped heart that we keep talking for TOF. So it all occurs because of hypertrophy of the right ventricle, because of which it gets uplifted like this and uplifted like this above the diaphragm than the normal, and it gets positioned horizontally towards the left chest wall. So hilar area and lung fields are relatively clean because it is an oligemic condition. क्यों? क्योंकि पल्मोनरी स्टेनोसिस है, वहां से ब्लड चेस्ट में आया ही नहीं. सो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, द लंग फील्ड्स वुड बी क्लियर. सो हाइलर एरिया एंड लंग फील्ड्स आर रिलेटिवली क्लीन ड्यू टू डिमिनिश्ड पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो और स्मॉल साइज पल्मोनरी आर्टरीज और बोथ. Aorta is usually large and 20% can have right-sided aortic arch also that causes an indentation of the leftward position heart. And air-filled tracheobronchial shadows can be seen sometimes in the X-ray. So once you appreciate the X-ray and all the findings that we have seen, can you see this knob-like structure? Can you appreciate the concavity of the heart? Can you see how the right ventricle has got lifted up? Okay, so this entire picture is what we have discussed. If you trace it completely like this, what do you see? It looks like a shoe. So that is why TOF mein hum kya bolte, we get a boot shaped heart. So this is what is the boot and this is how you draw the boot. So if you have understood the concept, you can easily correlate why is the boot shaped heart found in TOF. Okay, if you go by the ECG, what will you see? Once we do the ECG, there is going to be right axis deviation. Why? Because there is right ventricular hypertrophy. So there is dominant R wave in the right precordial chest leads. जब भी आप chest leads देखोगे, जो आपके right side के chest leads होते हैं, वहाँ पे हमेशा आपको dominant R wave दिखेगा. There can be a positive T wave in leads V3 and V1, and P wave is tall and peaked, suggesting there is right atrial enlargement as well. So finally, you will find four important findings. The most important finding is right axis deviation. You can see both the tall waves in 1 and 3 reaching out to each other. So that is how you can appreciate a right ventricular hypertrophy. In all the right-sided chest leads, you would find a dominant R pattern. There is a positive T wave which you can appreciate in the third and the first chest leads. And the P wave is tall and it is peaked. That is because of the atrial enlargement that can occur after the right ventricular enlargement. ठीक है, इफ यू डू अ 2D एको, व्हाट विल यू सी? सो डायग्नोसिस ऑन 2D एको इज कंफर्मेटरी फॉर TOF. व्हाई? Because you can see the location and the amount of RVOT that is present. You can appreciate the size of the pulmonary wall. You can see where are the pulmonary branch arteries. ठीक है, जितने भी branch arteries और collaterals है वो कहाँ पे है. You can see the side of the aortic arch, right है या left है. You can see whether there is a PDA which is supplying the pulmonary blood flow or not. And what is the status of pulmonary atresia. तो जितने भी फीचर्स हमने पढ़े हैं रिगार्डिंग TOF, एवरीथिंग यू कैन अप्रिशिएट ऑन अ इको. सो डेफिनेटली दैट इज द कंफर्मेटरी डायग्नोसिस, दैट कंफर्मेटरी इन्वेस्टिगेशन दैट वी कैन डू टू डायग्नोस टेट्रोलॉजी ऑफ फेलो. कार्डियक कैथेटराइजेशन इज ओनली नीडेड फॉर MCQs, इट इज नॉट डन नाउ. So it will show you that the systolic pressure in the right ventricle is equal to the systemic pressure since the right ventricle is connected directly to the overriding of aorta. So systemic pressure हमें मिलता है, उतना ही pressure आपको right ventricle में भी मिलेगा. So this is because of the abnormal connection that is there. And the pulmonary artery pressure is usually lower than by 5 to 10 degree mm of Hg. ठीक है, सो कार्डियक कैथेटराइजेशन इज ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एमसीक्यू. यू शुड नो दैट इट डायरेक्टली मेजर्स द प्रेशर चेंजेस एंड दैट इज हाउ यू कैन डिटरमिन द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी बिहाइंड इट. इफ यू डू अ कार्डियक सीटी, यू नीड टू सी द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ऑल द मेन पल्मोनरी आर्टरी एंड इट्स कोलेटरल्स, एंड इट इज ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द इंटरवेंशन दैट वी नीड टू डू. ठीक है, सो दैट इज हाउ वी come towards the investigations. So cardiac CT is important only for surgical point of view. So moving on to the complications, two important complications that you have to know, that is cerebral thrombosis and brain abscess. Okay, apart from this, endocarditis can also occur in patients of TOF, but thrombosis and abscess is very, very important. So thrombosis basically occurs in your brain vessels, that is your cerebral veins or the dural sinuses. It occurs if there is extreme polycythemia and any reason which causes dehydration in the patient. So there is extreme polycythemia, what will happen? This high dense blood कैन गो एंड ब्लॉक द वेसल्स, ठीक है। सो अगर वेसल्स आपके ब्लॉक हो जाएंगे, इट कैन लीड टू साइनस थ्रोम्बोसिस, बिकॉज ऑफ विच द पेशेंट कैन हैव सडन फीचर्स ऑफ सेरेब्रोवैस्कुलर एक्सीडेंट्स एंड देर कैन बी सडन ऑनसेट ऑफ हेमीपैरेसिस इन दीज पेशेंट्स ऑफ टॉफ। सो एक्सट्रीम पॉलीसाइथीमिया एंड डिहाइड्रेशन टू आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉजेज विच कैन लीड टू सेरेब्रल वेन एंड ड्यूरल साइनस थ्रोम्बोसिस, ठीक है। इट इज यूजुअली सीन इन पेशेंट्स लेस देन 2 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, क्योंकि लेस देन 2 ईयर्स में ही डिहाइड्रेशन कॉमन होता है, बियॉन्ड दैट इट इज नॉट वेरी कॉमन। सो पॉलीसाइथीमिया अगर है भी तो इट्स नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, इट विल डेफिनेटली लीड इन टू दीज काइंड ऑफ एक्सीडेंट्स, बट इफ पॉलीसाइथीमिया इज देयर एंड इट इज डिहाइड्रेटेड स्टेट, देन इट कैन लीड टू दीज काइंड ऑफ एक्सीडेंट्स, ठीक है। यूजुअली दे ऑल्सो हैव आयरन डेफिशियंसी अनीमिया एंड फ्रीक्वेंटली दे कैन हैव नॉर्मल हीमोग्लोबिन एज वेल। सो वट वी नीड टू ट्रीट देम, वी नीड टू ट्रीट देम विद एडिक्वेट हाइड्रेशन, ठीक है। एंड वी नीड टू डू फ्लेबोटोमी सो दैट यू कैन रिमूव द पॉलीसाइथीमिया दैट इज प्रेजेंट, ठीक है। सो हाइड्रेशन एंड फ्लेबोटोमी आर टू इम्पॉर्टेंट मैनेजमेंट दैट यू कैन डू टू प्रिवेंट सेरेब्रल थ्रोम्बोसिस इन अ पेशेंट हु इज ऑलरेडी पॉलीसाइथेमिक and can have a very high risk of developing cerebrovascular accidents. Then there is another condition, brain abscess. ये होता है more than 2 years of age में. Again, the patient is going to have insidious onset of fever. There can be changes in behavior, nausea, vomiting, and features of raised ICP. So this abscess is formed in the brain, which is going to lead to features of raised ICP in TOF patients. So there is going to be presence of neurological signs. Once you do investigations, that is your contrast enhanced MRI, you can find that there is an enhancing lesion. That is because of the presence of abscess in the head. ठीक है, सो यू ओनली हैव टू मैनेज विद कंप्लीट कोर्स ऑफ एंटीबायोटिक्स एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो डू अ सर्जिकल ड्रेनेज इफ इट इज वेरी वेरी ग्रेव। नाउ बैक्टीरियल एंडोकाइटाइटिस कैन अकर, क्यों? क्योंकि राइट वेंट्रिकल से क्या हो रहा है, यूजुअली ऑन द राइट वेंट्रिकुलर इनफंडिबुलम इट कैन कॉम्प्लिकेट। सो इन्फेक्शन कैन अकर बिकॉज ऑफ द आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन। सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू गिव प्रोफाइलैक्सिस एट टाइम्स टू पेशेंट्स ऑफ टॉफ एंड इट कैन ऑल्सो कॉम्प्लिकेट द शंट सर्जरी दैट हैज बीन प्लान्ड। So that is very, very important. Endocarditis is also another complication that can occur. So क्योंकि TOF में हमारे पास इतने सारे anomalies थे, so there are other congenital anomalies which can be related to TOF. So a TOF patient can again have PDA. There can be right, TOF patient can also have an associated PDA. There is right aortic arch which is seen in 20% patients. There is multiple VSTs which can be there. There can be Down syndrome association. There can be absence of pulmonary wall. There can be absence of branch pulmonary artery. It can be related to Digeorge syndrome and also Catch-22 syndrome. ठीक है, so you should remember the associations of TOF. It is related with Catch-22 and Digeorge syndrome also. ठीक है, so it's not that TOF is totally sporadic. It can be associated with these syndromes as well. So coming to the treatment part, so medically we only have to manage the hypoxic spell. So once the child goes into hypoxic spell, the child needs to be treated promptly. It is very important to educate the parents to do a knee chest position and to explain them the sequence of events that can occur. So you can put the baby on prophylaxis with propranolol therapy, which is given at the dose of 0.5 to 1 mg per kg per day. So it can be given to these patients so that they do not go up into cyanotic spells. If there is iron deficiency, you have to treat it immediately because you cannot afford a fall in hemoglobin. Okay, so jitne bhi nutritional causes hai for decrease in hemoglobin, you have to treat them because iron deficient children will again be susceptible to cerebrovascular complications because of formation of thrombosis. So after medical management, we refer to these patients for surgical correction. So surgery mein hamare paas palliative shunt procedures hote hain. So shunt procedures are performed to increase the pulmonary blood flow. Kab karate hain hum surgical correction TOF mein? Definitely if there is a newborn who has TOF jisme complete pulmonary atresia hai. So if there is a complete pulmonary atresia, there won't be any blood flow that is occurring from the pulmonary tract. So in these cases, we need to operate these kind of children. If there is infants who have hypoplastic pulmonary annulus, if there are children with hypoplastic pulmonary arteries, there is unfavorable coronary artery anatomy. Infants younger than 3 to 4 months old who have medically unmanageable hypoxic spells and infants who are less than 2.5 kg. So in these cases, you need to operate immediately. Any case which has got complete pulmonary atresia, ठीक है, उन सबको ऑपरेट करना है. ठीक है, सो नियोनेट्स हु हैव ट्रॉफ विद पल्मोनरी एट्रेसिया, दोज हु हैव हाइपोप्लास्टिक पल्मोनरी एनुलस, अगेन मीनिंग द राइट वेंट्रिकुलर आउटफ्लो ट्रैक्ट इज कंप्लीटली हाइपोप्लास्टिक, चिल्ड्रन हु हैव हाइपोप्लास्टिक पल्मोनरी आर्टरी इटसेल्फ, सो ब्लड जाएगा कहाँ से, सो अगेन यू नीड टू ऑपरेट, जिसमें अनफेवरेबल कोरोनरी आर्टरी एनाटॉमी है. दोज इन्फेंट्स हु आर यंगर देन 3 to 4 months एंड इन होम द हाइपोक्सिक स्पेल मैनेजमेंट इज बिकमिंग डिफिकल्ट, यू कैन ऑपरेट देम. एंड फॉर दोज इन्फेंट्स हु वेट लेस देन 2.5 kg, सो वी हैव गॉट द शंट प्रोसीजर्स दैट इज अवेलेबल. सो विद दिस शंटिंग वट वी डू, वी ट्राई टू प्रोटेक्ट, मेक अ कनेक्शन बिटवीन द पल्मोनरी ट्रंक एंड द एओर्टिक पार्ट. ठीक है, इनके बीच में अगर कनेक्शन बन जाएगा तो ब्लड यहाँ से यहाँ फ्लो कर जाएगा, दिस ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन कैन बी रिलीव्ड. ठीक है, सो वी हैव अ क्लासिकल ब्लैलॉक टॉसिंग शंट, जिसमें हम क्या करते हैं, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, सब क्लेवियन आर्टरी से पल्मोनरी आर्टरी के बीच में कनेक्शन बना देते हैं. सो एनास्टेमोसिस बिटवीन द सब क्लेवियन आर्टरी एंड द इप्सिलेटरल पल्मोनरी आर्टरी इज अ ब्लॉक टॉसिंग शंट. नाउ वी हैव अ मॉडिफाइड फॉर्म ऑफ बीटी शंट, जिसमें हम इंटरपोजिशन शंट प्लेस कर देते हैं बिटवीन द सब क्लेवियन आर्टरी एंड द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी. दिस इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर मेथड दैट वी आर यूजिंग एट दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइम. नाउ फॉर योर एमसीक्यू पर्पस, यू जस्ट नीड टू नो द नेम ऑफ द शंट एंड व्हाट इज द process that we do, they are not done anymore very commonly. So there's another one known as Watterson shunt. So Watterson में हम क्या करते हैं, ascending aorta को pulmonary artery से connect कर देते हैं. Then there is pot surgery. In this what we do, in this we connect descending aorta to left pulmonary artery. Again it is not done. And then we have the option of complete repair surgery. So complete repair में हम क्या करते हैं, in the first year of life, and we need to do a complete repair of all the defects that is present, and it is carried out under cardiopulmonary bypass surgery. So for this we need to also get the CT scan done, so that we are aware of all the vessels, all the collaterals that has occurred because of the complete atresia of the pulmonary artery. So this is how we treat a patient of TOF. So I hope you have understand tetralogy of Fallot, most important topic of cyanosis and cyanotic heart disease. If you still have any doubts, please ask me. I can clear it. I can repeat anything that is there. Cerebral abscess and thrombosis I've already explained. It all occurs because of repeated infections, which can lead to abscess, and thrombosis is because of the polycythemia and blockage. So any doubts till now, please ask me. TOF should be very, very clear with you. There shouldn't be any doubts regarding tetralogy of Fallot, because it's very commonly asked in the exam, must know topic, and definite MCQ can come from here. So you should be very clear with the concept, so that any kind of question that is asked, you are able to answer it. So if everything is clear, you can leave a thumbs up so that we can start with other cyanotic heart diseases. Okay, so we will see the next one, that is tricuspid atresia. So as the name says, what is going to happen? This is the four chamber view. जो हमारा ट्राइकस्पिड एरिया होता है उसका अट्रेजिया हो गया, दैट मीन्स द ट्राइकस्पिड एरिया इज नो मोर फंक्शनल. ठीक है, सो दिस कंडीशन इज वेयर देयर इज नो ट्राइकस्पिड वॉल्व. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, जिस ब्लड को राइट एट्रिया से राइट वेंट्रिकल में जाना था, दैट ब्लड इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी एबल टू फ्लो. सो ब्लड यहाँ से यहाँ तो जा नहीं पाया, फिर कहाँ जाएगा, इधर से इधर. कैसे जाएगा, पेटेंट फोरामेन ओवेल के थ्रू. ठीक है, सो द ब्लड इन द राइट एट्रिया विल गो फ्रॉम फोरामेन ओवेल टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट एट्रिया, फ्रॉम लेफ्ट एट्रिया इट विल गो टू लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल, देन इट विल गो टू आयोटा. सो देयर इज कंप्लीट मिक्सिंग ऑफ द ऑक्सीजनेटेड एंड द अनऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, देयर विल बी कंप्लीट मिक्सिंग ऑफ द ब्लड, बिकॉज ऑफ विच द डर्टी ब्लड विल अगेन एंटर द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल, और यहाँ से हमारी पूरी बॉडी में जाएगा. सो पेशेंट को क्या हो जाएगा, साइनोसिस. ठीक है, ट्राइकस्पिड एट्रेसिया डिफेक्ट इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द फॉलोइंग. सो देयर विल बी अ स्मॉल राइट वेंट्रिकल. क्यों, क्योंकि एट्रेसिया हो गया, सो वट एवर हैड टू गो टू राइट वेंट्रिकल इज नॉट गोइंग, सो राइट वेंट्रिकल विल बिकम स्मॉल. देयर इज गोइंग टू बी अ लार्ज लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल. व्हाई, बिकॉज सारा लोड कहाँ जा रहा है, लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल पे. राइट एट्रिया से ब्लड लेफ्ट एट्रिया में गया, लेफ्ट एट्रिया से लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल पे गया, सो साइज ऑफ लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. There can also be a small VST and PDA because there is no connection from right atria to ventricle. So to establish the connection between these two, there can be a small VST and PDA also. There's diminished pulmonary circulation. Obviously, right ventricle mein kuch gaya hi nahi, toh pulmonary circulation would be decreased. And cyanosis is definite definitely going to occur in tricuspid atresia because there is apparent mixing of the blood and the dirty blood is going to the whole body of the patient. So clinically, what will happen? Cyanosis would be present right from the birth क्योंकि right atria से left right ventricle में तो blood जा ही नहीं पा रहा, so आगे जाने का कोई सवाल ही नहीं है. So सारा blood कहाँ जा रहा? Left side पे. So left side में shunting के वजह से what is going to happen? Cyanosis will occur right from birth. There will be tachypnea and poor feeding which occurs because of respiratory distress. There's history of hypoxic spell which will be present in infant with this condition. So sudden onset of cyanosis is classically seen right at birth and there can be history of spells also. Okay, so these are the classical presentation that you can see in tricuspid atresia. If you come to examine these patients, cyanosis would definitely be present. They can be present with clubbing or not. Clubbing only occurs if there is long standing feature of desaturation. Okay, clubbing mein basically kya hote hai? Aapke nail beds ke andar ke jo AV capillaries hote, they get dilated and distended. So that occurs if desaturation is present for a very profound amount, for a very prolonged amount of time. So it is a classical feature of respiratory illness, but आपके cardiac में भी होते हैं. Cardiac में TOF में it can occur easily because again TOF patients have a prolonged desaturation episodes. So because of which it can occur in patients of TOF. Similarly, अगर tricuspid atresia long standing है, that means after few years, then you can see clubbing in these kind of patients. If you auscultate, you will find a systolic thrill, which is rarely palpable when associated with pulmonary stenosis. So you can find grade 2 to grade 3 by 6 polar systolic murmur, that is the early systolic murmur of VST, which is usually present at the left lower sternal border. Okay, so systolic thrill may not be palpable, but you can easily get an early systolic murmur in patients of tricuspid atresia. Okay, if you do the ECG, what will happen? Sara load kahan ja raha? Left ventricle pe. So left ventricle hypertrophy is definitely present. Now there can be right atrial hypertrophy or biatrial hypertrophy kyunki right ventricle mein to kuch ja nahi pa raha. So load kahan pe? Mainly aapka right atria mein. Yahan se left atria mein bhi ja sakta hai. So both the atrias can enlarge. So biatrial hypertrophy can be present in patients of tricuspid atresia. ठीक है, क्लियर है. एक्सरे करोगे तो क्या मिलेगा? हार्ट साइज कैन बी नॉर्मल और इट कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड आल्सो क्योंकि आपका राइट एट्रिया भी इंक्रीज्ड है और आपका लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल का साइज भी इंक्रीज्ड है. सो माइल्ड एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द हार्ट कैन बी सीन ऑन एक्सरे. इफ यू डू अ 2D एको, यू कैन सी ऑल द फाइंडिंग्स. द ट्राइकस्पिड ऑरिफिस वुड बी एब्सेंट. देयर कैन बी मार्क्ड हाइपोप्लेसिया ऑफ राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड देयर इज अ लार्ज लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल व्हिच कैन बी इमेज्ड इन द 4 चेंबर व्यू इजीली. So medically, what will you do? A tricuspid atresia, so we need to establish an alternate pathway. So if the child presents with cyanosis at birth, what we can do? The ductus can be kept open. So should be a PGE1 can be started in neonates who have severe cyanosis to maintain the patency of the ductus before planned cardiac catheterization or cardiac surgery. So we need to keep this alternate pathway open so that the child can have adequate supply of the blood to the whole body. So for that we need to keep the ductus open to maintain the connection of blood between the pulmonary and the aortic part. So for this we can start the PGE1 infusion till the surgery is completed. So just remember the name Rashkind procedure. Rashkind procedure is the thing that is done before the surgical exact correction surgery. Okay, to maintain the shunt and to improve the clinical condition of the patient. So Rashkind procedure is used where it is used in truncus arteriosus. Okay, any doubts? Sorry, tricuspid atresia. Any doubts till now that you have? Please, you can ask me. ठीक है, इज इट वेरी क्लियर? ट्राइकस्पिड एट्रेजिया 4 चेंबर व्यू इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो देर इज नो ट्राइकस्पिड पार्ट बिकॉज ऑफ विच एवरीथिंग गोज टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द हार्ट. राइट वेंट्रिकल में नथिंग इज गोइंग टू कम. राइट एट्रिया से एवरीथिंग विल गो टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट एट्रिया. फ्रॉम लेफ्ट एट्रिया टू लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल एंड द सेम डिऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड विल गो टुवर्ड्स द होल बॉडी ऑफ द पेशेंट. So that is about the mechanics. If you have understood the mechanics, you would know patient can present with cyanosis at birth, can have respiratory distress, will have hypoxic spells, there can be cyanosis on examination, systolic thrill can be rarely palpable but a holosystolic murmur is present. Left ventricular hypertrophy is classically seen because the whole load goes on the left ventricle, but the atrias can be enlarged equally, so a biatrial hypertrophy is also seen. On X-ray, the heart size can be increased or it can be normal, but there is enlargement of the right atria and the left ventricle. When you do a 2D echo, you can easily see that the tricuspid orifice is absent and the right ventricle has become small. So for management, you need to keep the duct open so that there's adequate amount of connection between the pulmonary and the aortic part. So this communication is patent. You can wait till the surgery because the baby is going to have adequate blood flow. Okay? So this connection is going to be present through the PDA. Dash kind procedure name, you should know that this is done to maintain the shunt between the two parts, the right and the left part, so that the patient can undergo a complete surgical correction of the deformity. Okay, so any doubts, again you can ask. Cerebrovascular accidents can occur because of the polycythemia, because there can be blockage of the blood vessels, which can lead to complete obstruction to the blood flow, because of which the patient can have features of cerebrovascular accidents. PDA can be present because PDA is present in every baby. It's a normal phenomena. If it gets closed, that is normal, but if it remains patent, that is abnormal. So to maintain the communication between the pulmonary part and the aortic part, if this patent ductus arteriosus is present, then the communication can be maintained, because right ventricle ke niche to kuch aa nahi raha, so yahan se lungs mein nothing is going to go. Right, so to maintain that communication between right and left, the patent ductus arteriosus can be kept patent through the infusion of PGE1, so that the communication is intact. So that is what we do deliberately to save the baby from severe cyanosis till the surgery can be arranged. Okay, so can we move to transposition of the great arteries? So TGA is very, very important again. So these are very important cyanotic heart diseases that needs to be mastered. Is TGA mein kya hota hai? Jaisa naam hai, transposition of great arteries. So do great artery hum tab se four chambered view mein padh rahe hain. Ek to pulmonary aur ek aorta hai. So isme kya hoga? There is going to be transposition. There matlab aapka pulmonary part is taraf ko aa jayega aur aortic part is taraf ko connect ho jayega. Theek hai? So if you just imagine the mixing of these two or transposition of these two important vascular channels, so what will happen? Aorta gets connected to the right ventricle and the pulmonary artery gets connected to the left ventricle. Theek hai? So oxygen poor blood, that is the dirty blood, is going to return where? To the right atria. From the body, right atria se kahan aayega? From body, right atria se right ventricle mein aayega. Aur right ventricle se kahan jana tha? Lungs mein jana tha to get cleared. Now, where it will go? This dirty blood will go directly to the body through the aorta. Okay, yahan pe aorta aa gaya. Similarly, oxygen rich blood, jo hamare body mein left atria mein hai, jo lungs se clear hoke aaya hai, wo left atria se kahan jayega? Left ventricle mein. Left ventricle se use kahan jana tha? Aorta mein, and then to the whole body. But ab wo kahan jayega? Ab wo pulmonary artery se back to the lungs gaya. To kya fayda hua lungs ka to clear all the blood? So this is an anomalous connection that has occurred because of the transposition of these two important arteries. Yes, tricuspid atresia also, there is going to be similar phenomena. So pulmonary communication can be established through the PDA. Okay? So TGA mein, you can just imagine, yahan pe aapka aorta aa gaya aur yahan pe pulmonary part aa gaya. So the whole blood channel process that we had studied in normal four chamber view, wo sara reverse ho gaya. All the dirty blood is going in the body, all the clean blood is returning back to the lungs. So other heart defects which can also be associated with TGA could be atrial and ventricular septal defects. May be necessary in order for the infant with TGA to survive, kyunki agar hamara sara blood mix ho raha hai aur sara blood lungs mein wapas ja raha hai, we need some kind of shunt so that the blood can go from one side of the heart to the other. So to allow mixing of the blood deliberately, these children need to have AST or VST so that they can have smaller amount of bloods which can be interchanged between right and left chambers. So clinically, what will happen? There can be cyanosis right from the birth, because there is mixing of blood right from the birth. Okay? Signs of CHF can be present with dyspnea and feeding difficulties which develop during the newborn period. There can be moderate to severe cyanosis in these kind of patients because there is severe mixing of the blood and whatever purified blood has come out from the lungs is not able to go to the body. The second heart sound is again single and loud because there will be no separate component. And if CHF occurs, the patient can develop dyspnea and enlarged liver size or hepatomegaly. So cyanosis, CHF is very, very important in TGA. So heart failure can occur. There can be breathing difficulties. There can be feeding difficulties as well. And the patient can also present with severe cyanosis. So once you do the ECG, what will you find? There is a rightward axis deviation which can occur because of right ventricular hypertrophy. ठीक है. बाई वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी कॉमन विच कैन बी सीन. सो राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड बाई वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी कैन अकर इन टीजीए एंड ओकेजनली राइट एट्रियल हाइपरट्रॉफी कैन ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट. ठीक है. सो अगर ये हमारा फोर चेम्बर व्यू है तो राइट वेंट्रिकल इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू गेट एनलार्ज्ड बिकॉज दिस ब्लड को हमारा यहाँ से पंप आउट होकर लंग्स में जाना था. दैट इज नॉट गोइंग. इट इज गोइंग टू गेट मिक्सड अप विद द लेफ्ट साइडेड ब्लड क्योंकि यहाँ पे हमारा अयोटा आ गया. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट अ लॉट ऑफ मिक्सिंग ऑफ द ब्लड बिकॉज ऑफ विच साइनोसिस कैन अकर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द शंटिंग ऑफ द ब्लड दैट इज गोइंग टू अकर ड्यू टू ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन टू द नॉर्मल फ्लो. देर कैन बी राइट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी एंड देर कैन बी लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी इक्वली बिकॉज बोथ द साइड ऑफ द चेम्बर्स आर अफेक्टेड ड्यू टू मैल पोजिशनिंग ऑफ द आर्टरीज. सो वी कैन हैव अ बाई वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रॉफी. ठीक है. अगर हम 2D एको करेंगे देखने के लिए तो हमें क्या मिलेगा. यू कैन सी दैट द नॉर्मल कनेक्शन दैट इज जिसको हम सर्कल एंड सॉसेज अपियरेंस कहते हैं ऑफ द नॉर्मल ग्रेट आर्टरीज दैट इज नॉट विजिबल. सो अगर आर्टरीज सही जगह पे है ही नहीं तो नॉर्मल चीज कैसे दिखेगी. सो द नॉर्मल सर्कल एंड सॉसेज अपियरेंस विच वी एक्सपेक्ट आउट ऑफ दीज इंपॉर्टेंट वेसल्स दैट इज गोइंग टू बी लॉस्ट. इन द अपाइकल एंड सबकॉस्टल 5 चेम्बर व्यू द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी अराइजेस फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल एंड द अयोटा अराइजेस फ्रॉम द राइट वेंट्रिकल. और एक्सरे हम करेंगे तो हमें क्या मिलेगा. कार्डियोमेगली वुड बी प्रेजेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपरट्रॉफी ऑफ दीज चेम्बर्स एंड एग शेप्ड कार्डियक सिलहाउटी. सो टीजीए में हम क्या कहते हैं. एग ऑन साइड. ठीक है. एग ऑन साइड अपियरेंस इज वॉट वी क्लासिकली सीन इन टीजीए. तो मैनेजमेंट में हम क्या करेंगे. मेडिकली वी नीड टू मैनेज. सो मेडिकली वी हैव टू करेक्ट द डिसैचुरेशन दैट इज प्रेजेंट सो दैट द चाइल्ड इज नॉट गोइंग टू मेटाबॉलिक एसिडोसिस. सो इफ वी वॉन्ट टू न्यूबॉर्न पीरियड में अगर ये साइनोसिस के साथ आता है सो वॉट वी require the most, we require the most to do a surgical correction and also we require a normal connection between right and left side of the heart. ठीक है. तो इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे. PGE1 infusion can be started so that we can attain a reopening of the ductus arteriosus. So once the ductus connection established, what will happen? Pulmonary or aortic में normal connection हो जाएगा because of which the blood can flow from right towards the left. So जो abnormal connection हो रहा था, all the dirty blood was going in the body and all the clean blood was returning to the lungs. We want to prevent that so we can keep this ductus open so that the blood has a normal opening, a normal channel to follow from right towards the left. So PGE1 infusion is again life-saving over here. Apart from this, oxygen can be given and what we do is known as a balloon atrial septostomy, which can be performed to increase the mixing of the mixing by opening the atrial septum. ठीक है. सो हमें अगर इनको सर्वाइव कराना होता है सो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट क्या होता है. वी अलाउ अ राइट टू लेफ्ट शंट. ठीक है. सो अगर हम यहाँ एट्रियल सेप्टोस्टोमी कर देंगे तो क्या होगा. राइट का ब्लड लेफ्ट में इट कैन गो. सो इट कैन बी परफॉर्म बाय मिक्सिंग द मिक्सिंग बाय ओपनिंग द एट्रियल सेप्टम. सो दिस मिक्सिंग कैन बी डेलिबरेटली बी अलाउड बाय ओपनिंग द एट्रियल सेप्टम. सो दैट इज अगेन अ लाइफ सेविंग प्रोसीजर टिल वी डू अ कंप्लीट सर्जिकल करेक्शन एंड इट इज प्लान प्रॉपरली. फॉर लाइफ सेविंग वी कैन ईदर कीप द डक्टस ऑफ द चाइल्ड ओपन और वी कैन डू अ बलून एट्रियल सेप्टोस्टोमी सो दैट द शिफ्ट ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम राइट टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द हार्ट इज अलाउड. ठीक है. एनी डाउट्स टिल नाउ प्लीज आस्क मी. आर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीजेस. सो इफ यू जस्ट सिंपली अंडरस्टैंड द 4 चेम्बर व्यू यू कैन आंसर सिंपली इन द एग्जाम्स. द कंसेप्ट शुड बी वेरी वेरी क्लियर. ठीक है. सो टीजीए में कौन सा वेसल कहाँ है और कहाँ से कहाँ जाता है ये सब समझ में आ जाना चाहिए सो दैट यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट द क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग यू. सो लास्ट आई थिंक वी हैव TAPVR दैट इज टोटल एनोमलस पल्मोनरी वीनस रिटर्न. सो इसमें क्या हो रहा है. टोटल एनोमलस पल्मोनरी वीनस रिटर्न. सो व्हाट डज द नेम से दैट देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन द पल्मोनरी वेन्स एंड द लेफ्ट एट्रिया एंड दे ड्रेन एनोमसली इनटू द सिस्टमिक वीनस ट्रिब्यूटरीज और इनटू द राइट एट्रिया. सो जो रिटर्न ऑफ द ब्लड आना था हमारा पल्मोनरी पार्ट से वो नहीं हो पा रहा अच्छे से. व्हाई. बिकॉज देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन द पल्मोनरी वेन्स एंड द लेफ्ट एट्रिया एंड इट ड्रेन्स एनोमसली इनटू द सिस्टमिक वीनस ट्रिब्यूटरीज और इट गोज बैक टू द राइट एट्रिया. सो ये एनोमलस पल्मोनरी वीनस रिटर्न हो गया. ठीक है. इसके 4 टाइप होते हैं. सुपरा कार्डियक, कार्डियक, इंफ्रा कार्डियक एंड मिक्सड. सुपरा कार्डियक किसको कहते हैं. विच इज द मोस्ट कॉमन टाइप ऑल्सो द मोस्ट द कॉमन पल्मोनरी वीनस साइनस ड्रेन्स इनटू द राइट सुपीरियर वेना कावा. सो ये हमारा 4 चेम्बर व्यू है. ठीक है. राइट एट्रिया, राइट वेंट्रिकल, लेफ्ट एट्रिया, लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल. यहाँ से पल्मोनरी वेसल्स जा रहे हैं यहाँ पे लंग्स से, प्यूरिफाई होके वेन्स के थ्रू लेफ्ट एट्रिया में आना था, फिर लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल में जाना था, यहाँ से पूरे बॉडी में जाना था। ठीक है, जो ये वाले वेसल्स है ये रिटर्न प्रॉपर दे नहीं रहे, या तो ये आपके राइट एट्रिया में चले गए या तो किसी और ब्लड वेसल से जाके कनेक्ट हो गए। सो दिस इज व्हाट इज टोटल एनोमलस पल्मोनरी वीनस रिटर्न। जो वीनस रिटर्न आ रहा है पल्मोनरी वेसल से वो ठीक से नहीं आ रहा, कहाँ जा रहा है, या तो राइट एट्रिया में घुस गया या किसी और ब्लड वेसल को ज्वाइन कर लिया। ठीक है, सो सुप्रा कार्डियक में क्या होता है, दीज पल्मोनरी वीनस साइनसेस विल गो एंड ड्रेन इन टू द राइट सुपीरियर वेना कावा। यहाँ से राइट सुपीरियर वेना कावा आता है और आईवीसी आते हैं। सो अगर ये राइट सुपीरियर वेना कावा में खुल गया सो दैट इज सुप्रा कार्डियक टीएपीवीसी। कार्डियक में क्या होता है, द कॉमन पल्मोनरी वीनस साइनस ड्रेन्स इन टू द कोरोनरी साइनस। अगर ये राइट एसवीसी के बजाय कोरोनरी साइनस में चला गया सो उसको हम कार्डियक टाइप कहते हैं। इंफ्रा कार्डियक क्या होता है, अगर कॉमन पल्मोनरी वीनस साइनस ड्रेन्स इनटू द पोर्टल वेन और डक्टस विनोसस और हेपेटिक वेन और इंफीरियर वेना कावा, जो हमारा आईवीसी का पार्ट आ रहा है, इफ एनी ऑफ दीज पार्ट्स आर यूज्ड फॉर ड्रेनेज देन व्हाट विल हैपन, इट इज नोन एज इंफ्रा कार्डियक टीएपीवीआर। एंड मिक्स टाइप में क्या होता है, इफ देयर इज एनी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द अबव दैट वी हैव मेंशन देन इट इज द मिक्स टाइप। ठीक है, सो इसमें से मोस्ट कॉमन कौन सा है, मोस्ट कॉमन इज द सुपरा कार्डियक टीएपीवीआर। ठीक है, पेशेंट कैसे प्रेजेंट करेगा हिस्ट्री, अगेन व्हाट विल हैपन, there can be CHF with growth retardation, definitely अगर CHF है तो growth retardation नहीं होगा, there can be frequent pulmonary infections because all the dirty blood is again going to the lungs also, there is no clearing of the blood, so that can lead to pulmonary infection and there can be cyanosis due to mixing of the blood. ठीक है, once you examine the child can have features of CHF, there can be undernourishment and precordial bulge, so precordial bulge is again because of what, right ventricular hypertrophy. ठीक है, अगर हम ईसीजी कराते हैं तो हमें क्या मिलता है, राइट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रोफी। एक्सरे कराएंगे तो क्या मिलेगा, कार्डियोमेगली बिकॉज ऑफ राइट वेंट्रिकुलर हाइपरट्रोफी, देयर इज कर्ली बी लाइंस। ठीक है, देयर कैन बी फिगर ऑफ एट स्ट्रक्चर, सो टीएपीवीआर में हमें क्लासिकली क्या मिलता है, फिगर ऑफ एट। टीजीए में क्या मिलता है, एग शेप्ड हार्ट। ठीक है, थ्री लेटर वर्ड टीजीए, थ्री लेटर वर्ड एग, सो एग ऑन द साइड इज सीन इन टीजीए। टॉफ में सबको पता है बूट शेप्ड हार्ट मिलता है। ठीक है, टी में टॉफ में ओ आर है, बूट्स में ओ आर है, एंड टी ए पी वी आर में हमें फिगर ऑफ एट मिलता है। ठीक है, फिगर ऑफ एट, सो दीज थ्री आर वेरी कॉमनली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस दैट कैन बी आस्क्ड अगेन एंड अगेन एज वन लाइनर, सो यू शुड बी नोइंग फिगर ऑफ एट या स्नोमैन साइन हमें टी ए पी वी आर में मिलता है। अगर हम इको करके देखेंगे तो वी विल सी अ लार्ज राइट एट्रिया, a small left atria with deviation of the atrial septum to the left and a dilated pulmonary artery is also present. ठीक है, ये हमारा हार्ट है, सो दिस इज हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू गो, सो दिस कंस्ट्रक्शन दैट इज अकरिंग ऑन बोथ साइड्स गिव राइज टू दिस काइंड ऑफ पिक्चर, इसको हम स्नोमैन भी कह सकते हैं और फिगर ऑफ एट भी कह सकते हैं। ठीक है, सो दिस इज व्हाट इज क्लासिकली सीन इन अ टीएपीवीआर पेशेंट, सो दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन दैट हैज अकर्ड राइट इन द सेंटर। मैनेज कैसे करोगे, सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेडिकली मैनेज, सो इंटेंसिव डीकंजेस्टिव थेरेपी टू रिलीव योर CHF, क्या क्या देते हैं, वी गिव डायोरेटिक्स एंड वी ऑल्सो नीड टू पुट ऑन आइनोट्रॉपिक सपोर्ट। ठीक है, सो दिस इज वॉट वी डू फॉर पेशेंट्स टू प्रिवेंट देम फ्रॉम CHF. Metabolic acidosis also needs to be corrected. Infants with severe pulmonary edema should be intubated and they can be put on ventilator support. So because there is too much of congestion in the lungs, ठीक है, इट कैन लीड टू पल्मोनरी इडीमा एज वेल, सो दीज पेशेंट्स रिक्वायर प्रॉपर इंट्यूबेशन एंड वेंटिलेटर सपोर्ट। नाउ इन सम पेशेंट्स दे कैन डेवलप लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन, दोज हु ऑलरेडी हैव पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन, PGE1 कैन इंक्रीज द सिस्टमिक फ्लो बाय कीपिंग द डक्टस ओपन। सो क्योंकि यहाँ भी हमारा रिटर्न कहाँ जा रहा है, एबनॉर्मल जगह पे जा रहा है, सो मेंटेन अ कॉमन कनेक्शन बिटवीन द पल्मोनरी एंड द aortic पार्ट, सो वी कैन ऑल्सो हैव द डक्ट ओपन। This is also one option that we can have, और open कैसे करते हैं, PGE1 के through। ठीक है, surgical correction में supracardiac is most commonly used for surgical correction, क्योंकि ये most common type है, so इसमें हमें बस connection को correct करना है, तो कैसे correct करेंगे, side to side anastomosis is made between the pulmonary venous sinus and the left atrium। ठीक है, जिस blood को हमारे pulmonary venous sinus में आना था, ठीक है, जो प्योरीफाई होके लंग से जिस ब्लड को लेफ्ट एट्रिया आना था वो यहाँ चला गया था SVC के पास, तो इसको हम हटा के वापस से लेफ्ट एट्रिया में डाल देंगे. सो दैट इज द सिंपल सर्जिकल करेक्शन दैट इज डन फॉर करेक्टिंग TAPVR इन विच द सुप्रा कार्डियक टाइप इज द मोस्ट कॉमन. और जो AST हमारे पास था उसको हम पैच क्लोजर करके बंद कर देंगे. So that is the simple surgical correction that is done for TAPVR. So I hope you have understand the concept behind all of the cyanotic heart disease. Abhi bhi koi doubt hai, please ask me. I can repeat any topic that you want. And if you have understood everything, you can leave a thumbs up. So I think cyanosis is very, very clear. I've already taken two sessions on the approach to cyanosis in which we have discussed all the important cyanotic heart diseases, just the names of them. And we have also discussed the approach to cyanosis. What is pulmonary cyanosis? What is cardiac cyanosis? How can we approach them? How can we differentiate? What are the investigations that we do? What are the findings that we get? And now I have completely described all the cyanotic heart diseases. सो मैकेनिक्स आपको अच्छे से पता होना चाहिए. इफ यू नो द मैकेनिक्स यू कैन इजिली आंसर एवरीथिंग इन द एग्जाम. ठीक है. सो इफ एनी डाउट इज स्टिल देयर प्लीज आस्क मी. इफ यू वॉन्ट एनी थिंग टू बी रिपीटेड आई एम स्टिल हियर फॉर 5 मिनट्स. सो फाइनली टू सम इट अप we have got oligemic lung fields and we have plethoric lung fields. So as we have discussed, oligemic lung fields ka kya matlab hota hai? Oligemic lung fields hote hai jab aapke chest x-ray mein aapke jo lung fields hai they are very very clear. So cleared out kyun hai ye? Because the pulmonary blood flow is obstructed. So because of which the blood is not going towards your pulmonary connection. अगर ब्लड आपके पल्मोनरी वेसल्स में नहीं जाएगा सो देर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी टू मच ऑफ कंजेशन एंड देर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी प्रॉब्लम और टू मच ऑफ कंजेशन देर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी एडिक्वेट फ्लो. एंड इफ देर इज स्टेनोसिस देन वॉट विल हैपन. इफ देर इज नो स्टेनोसिस और ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन देन वॉट विल हैपन. द पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो विल गो विद अ गश टुवर्ड्स योर लंग्स. सो दैट विल लीड टू प्लेथोरिक लंग फील्ड. सो प्लेथोरा बेसिकली मीन्स योर कंजेशन ऑफ द लंग फील्ड. सो दैट अकर्स वेन देर इज नो डिक्रीज pulmonary blood flow or there is no obstruction towards pulmonary blood flow. So ये दो चीज आपको याद रखना बहुत जरूरी है. You get always get questions on this chart that I'm showing you. Oligemic lung field is one clue and plethoric lung field is another clue. So किसी भी condition में अगर आपका component of pulmonary stenosis है, अगर कहीं से भी pulmonary stenosis या pulmonary atresia है, then what will happen? So that is going to cause डिक्रीज इन द पल्मोनरी ब्लड फ्लो. ठीक है. अगर स्टेनोसिस है या एट्रेजिया है तो क्या होगा? ब्लड फ्लो कम हो जाएगा लंग्स में. अगर कम हो जाएगा तो चेस्ट एक्सरे में कैसा दिखेगा? ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड्स. एंड इफ देर इज नो कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ योर स्टेनोसिस एंड एट्रेजिया देन वॉट विल हैपन? वट एवर ब्लड इज कमिंग टू राइट वेंट्रिकल दैट होल गश ऑफ ब्लड विल गो वेयर? इट विल गो कम्प्लीटली इन साइड योर लंग्स. सो इफ इट गोज टूवर्ड्स द लंग्स वट विल हैपन? द लंग विल गेट फ्लडेड विद सो मच ऑफ ब्लड. देर विल बी कंजेशन एंड दैट विल लीड टू प्लेथोरिक लंग फील्ड. सो ये डिफरेंशियल याद करने की जरूरत नहीं है, रटने की जरूरत नहीं है. अगर आपको कंसेप्ट पता है यू कैन ईजिली चूज फ्रॉम द ऑप्शन. नाउ इफ यू गेट अ ऑप्शन ऑफ पल्मोनरी एट्रेजिया विद BST एंड यू डोंट नो वट हैपन्स हियर, कैन यू सी पल्मोनरी एट्रेजिया इज देयर? एट्रेजिया का मतलब क्या हो गया? दैट पल्मोनरी पाथवे इज कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड. सो इफ इट इज कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड व्हाट विल हैपन? जो भी ब्लड राइट वेंट्रिकल के पास आया विल इट बी एबल टू गो टुवर्ड्स लंग्स? नो इट कैन नॉट गो. सो इफ इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू गो व्हाट विल हैपन? ओलिगेमिया विल बी प्रेजेंट. बट अगर यही क्वेश्चन में सिर्फ BST होता तो क्या आप ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड चूज करते? नो, यू शुड नॉट चूज बिकॉज यू शुड नो वेरी सिंपली फ्रॉम द लेक्चर्स एंड फ्रॉम ऑल द टीचिंग दैट हैज बीन डन कि BST में जो शंट होता है दैट मूव फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टूवर्ड्स द राइट. सो अगर राइट में सारा ब्लड वेंट्रिकल में आ गया, राइट वेंट्रिकल में, और पल्मोनरी पाथवे में कोई एट्रेजिया कोई स्टेनोसिस नहीं मेंशन किया, दैट मींस राइट वेंट्रिकल का सारा ब्लड कहाँ जा रहा है? जो ओवरलोडेड ब्लड है वो सारा ब्लड आपके लंग्स में जा रहा है. सो अगर लंग्स में ज्यादा ब्लड जाएगा तो क्या होगा? देयर इज गोइंग टू बी कंजेशन एंड प्लेथोरिक लंग फील्ड. ठीक है. सो ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड का डिफरेंशियल्स रटने की जरूरत नहीं है. यू कैन सिंपली सी इट इज पल्मोनरी एट्रेजिया विद BST. कॉमन सेंस क्रिटिकल पल्मोनरी स्टेनोसिस. अगेन कॉमन सेंस द पाथवे स्टेनोटिक. टॉफ डेफिनेटली क्योंकि टॉफ का एक कॉम्पोनेंट ही है पल्मोनरी स्टेनोसिस जो हमने अभी अभी पढ़ा है. सो पल्मोनरी स्टेनोसिस इज अ कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ टॉफ बिकॉज ऑफ विच डेफिनेटली इट विल हैव एन ओलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड्स. देन वी हैव DORV विद PS. सो अगेन इफ PS इज अ कॉम्पोनेंट देन वट विल हैपन? Because of that, there is going to be obstructed blood flow. If you have TA or PA with PS, ठीक है, अगर कोई सा भी atresia है और साथ में stenosis भी है, then what will happen? Again, the blood flow will not go freely towards the lungs. So it is going to lead to decreased pulmonary blood flow and therefore there is going to be oligemia. इफ यू हैव टीजीए विद पीएस देन अगेन व्हाट विल हैपन, अगर वीएसटी है भी टीजीए के पेशेंट को तो भी क्या होगा, जो भी ब्लड राइट वेंट्रिकल में अकोमोडेट हो रहा है वो ब्लड आपका बिकॉज ऑफ स्टेनोसिस विल नॉट बी एबल टू गो टुवर्ड्स द लंग्स विद दैट मच गश एंड पावर, सो इट विल नॉट लीड टू प्लेथोरा, इट विल लीड टू ऑलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड्स, क्योंकि ब्लड इज नॉट एबल टू गो आउट द स्टेनोटिक पाथवे. इसलिए ऑलिगेमिक लंग फील्ड्स कितने सारे डिफरेंशियल्स है विच कीप्स ऑन कमिंग इन ईच एंड एवरी एग्जाम, बट इफ यू नो द कंसेप्ट इट्स वेरी सिंपल टू पिक एंड चूज फ्रॉम द ऑप्शंस. सिमिलरली प्लेथोरिक लंग फील्ड्स कहाँ कहाँ मिलेंगे, जो भी कंडीशंस हमने पढ़े जहाँ पे आपके राइट वेंट्रिकल में ओवरलोड ऑफ ब्लड हो रहा था, सो इन ऑल दोस कंडीशंस यू आर गोइंग टू सी अ प्लेथोरिक लंग फील्ड लाइक टीजीए. ठीक है, टीजीए में क्या हो रही है, ट्रांसपोजिशन ऑफ ग्रेट आर्टरीज, सो राइट वेंट्रिकल के नीचे आपका अयोटा है ना, और साथ में शंटिंग भी हो रही है, सो ऑल द ब्लड इज अकोमोडेटिंग इन टू राइट वेंट्रिकल बिकॉज ऑफ विच इट इज गोइंग टू गो टूवर्ड्स द लंग्स. टीएपीवीआर में भी द सेम थिंग इज हैपनिंग, the ventricle, the right side can have extra load of blood because of abnormal connection. So what will happen? The whole blood will go into right ventricle again. So that will again lead to a plethoric lung field. There can be DORV. Again in this, the blood is accommodated into right ventricle. Because ventricle se hi outflow tract develop ho raha. So if it is in the right ventricle, then what will happen? Again, the blood can go with a gush towards the lungs. Persistent truncus arteriosus. So truncus arteriosus mein there's a single ventricle only. So everything is going to go towards the lungs. And single ventricle physiology is also a very important option to know. Jahan bhi single ventricle hai, wahan pe kya ho raha? Mixing of blood is there. And all the blood is going from right ventricle towards your lungs. So jitna blood lungs mein jayega utna plethora hoga. So these are the differentials of cyanosis and you should be clear with the concept. Don't try to mug it up. You can forget the next day only. So it is very, very important to understand the story behind the things, either concept wise or you can create your own story, but don't forget the things that you learn with so much of effort. Theek hai? So cardiac venous system CVS development I've already taken in the pediatric cardiology part 1. So we also have a special class from 9 to 11, so you can join over there to discuss about the CVS development. And if you want to recapitulate, you can hear the part 1 of pediatric cardiology. That was the first thing that we had discussed. Okay, so for all of those who are listening to YouTube, please go and download the Unacademy app on your phones. So we also have the Unacademy app in which you can follow the profile of the educator that you want to follow the lessons from. So if you like my way of teaching pediatrics, you can follow my profile by my name of Kavita Srivastav. And once you follow, you get all the updates about the classes and the lectures that I'm taking over there. So once you start to follow it, you will not miss on any class because you will get notified about all the classes that is being happening. So special classes is a very important feature that we have on the app. Here again, you have an interactive live class. So you get to interact with the participants. You get to chat with the educator so that all your doubts are cleared in the class itself. Then we have polls for the learners. So in this, you get to answer the polls. So polls mein basically kya hota hai? Jaise maine koi question pucha aapse, everybody who is listening to the topic is going to put an option. So you would also know ki aapne sahi kiya hai ya galat kiya hai. Aur agar sahi kiya hai, toh aapse pehle kitne logon ne sahi kiya hai? And also, what is the percentage of the population who knows the answer. So that gives you an idea or kind of a rank merit of your own assessment. So you know that where you are lying out of the fellows who are attending the class. So yehi aapke competitors hai jo sare classes attend kar rahe hai. So you should know ki haan aap kahan lie kar rahe ho and how many people know the answer. So you can boost up your preparation every time you see that so many people know the answer. So you have to attempt more and more question and you should know more and more topics so that you can push them behind. So polls say you get a rank of your own self and an assessment about your own self. Raise a hand feature is also there. So you can ask any doubt anytime in between the class so that you get clear with all the doubts that you have. And all your concept is clear. Then never miss a class is also there. So never miss a class is very important because you will get notified with all the notifications that we have. So whenever you are following any educator, so you won't miss any class because you get the messages that this class is going to happen at this particular time. So you can follow them and you can keep attending the educator class that you like the way of teaching from. ठीक है. देन वी ऑल्सो हैव लेक्चर नोट्स, सो ऑल ऑफ दोज हु आर अटेंडिंग द क्लासेस यू कैन डाउनलोड द नोट्स एंड यू कैन रिवाइज एंड री रिवाइज अगेन एंड अगेन फ्रॉम द सेम सेट ऑफ नोट्स विच इज द की टू सक्सेस. इफ यू फॉलो अ पर्टिकुलर कंसेप्ट अगेन एंड अगेन इट गेट्स वेरी वेरी क्लियर इन साइड यू. सो दैट इज वॉट वी ऑल नीड टू डू विद ऑल द 19 सब्जेक्ट्स. सो इफ यू लाइक एनी लेक्चर यू कैन डाउनलोड इट एंड यू कैन रीड फ्रॉम देयर. सो एनी टाइम एनी वेयर फैसिलिटीज देयर यू कैन डाउनलोड द ऐप. You can listen to these lectures from any of the devices and you can also attend the live classes and you can also get the recorded version. So, my next special class on the Unacademy app is going to occur on 18th of August at 6 p.m. where whatever cardiology that we have learned so much in detail on YouTube, I'm going to organize a marathon session or a pediatric quiz session where we are going to test our knowledge in pediatric cardiology and we'll see that whatever we have studied can be applied easily from the questions or not. So that is very important to see that you learn whatever you learn, whether you're able to apply it or not. So if you're able to apply it, that means that you are clear about it and you can answer any kind of questions asked from any type of format asked in any type of exam. So it is very important to clear your concepts so that you can answer everything the right way as it is expected in the exam. So we'll do a cardiology quiz on 18th of August. So I have organized it on this date so that you have ample time to read cardiology, revise it properly, and you're clear with the concept so that you can read the question, understand it, and then you can answer. Okay, so all of those who have attended regularly the YouTube sessions on pediatric cardiology, please come and attend the quiz on 18th of August at 6 p.m. So still those who are in the process of thinking kya join karna hai, kaha se padhna hai, kaise padhna hai, please come and join the Iconic or the Plus subscription. Take it a try. Honestly, it's going to benefit you a lot. It is very, very useful because you get a lot of things under this one subscription. You get the live classes, you get the test series, you get structured courses, you have a good plan of study, you get good study materials, you get to learn from the India's top educators, you get all the guidelines, your test analysis is also done. That means once you give the test, you get to know where you were wrong and what else could be done. So whatever mistakes that you are making, you get to learn from each and every mistake. So personal guidance is also given. If you take the Iconic subscription, that is the combo subscription, that is the best thing that you can do for your NEET PG preparation. You get yourself exposed to PrepLadder and also Unacademy. So once you do that, you would be very, very clear that yes, you can answer questions from two different forums. So you gain a lot of confidence inside you that whatever you have studied, that can be applied easily on the questions, and you can answer it from two different sources. So that means if any other new question comes in the exam and the topic that you have read nicely, you can still answer those questions. So a positive vibe hona bahut zaruri hota hai. You should be confident about your own self. So please take the Iconic subscription if you're still planning to take something, and if you take it, then you can start attempting the tests also. So ask a doubt option is always there. So whenever you have any problem out of whatever you are reading, whatever has been taught to you from Unacademy, you can click on the button and you can always ask the doubt on the app also. You can take the image of whatever question and whatever problem that you're having and you can post it where it gets solved and you get clarified of your doubts. So those who are still not downloaded the Unacademy app, guys, please go to the Play Store, download the app. It does not occupy a lot of space on your phone. It's a very useful app. So after you download, you can start using all the features. You can create your profile. You can start following your best educators that you like, and you can start listening to all the classes that is being organized for you. So to get a subscription, you simply have to download the app, go to the NEET PG option. So once you go to the NEET PG option, you have to select which subscription you want to take, Plus subscription or Iconic subscription. You have to choose the duration that you want to take. So please take it for a good amount of duration, because if you do that, you get the access to these classes for a good amount of time so that you can revise and revise from the same source again and again. So that is very, very important. And once you do that, you simply have to put a very nice code, which is going to drop down all the prices and you would get the great offers. So my code, that is KavitaS10, which I have told you in the beginning of the session also, you can put down that code and you would get all the great offers possible from Unacademy. So we also have a Bugs Bounty feature, which is going to give you the charges and the right to report any inappropriate content in the video. So if you do that and if you find anything like that, you can report it to the Unacademy. So we also have the Telegram channel. Please come and join this. Let's crack NEET PG. So this is the Telegram channel where you get all the updates about all the educators, all the classes that is happening. If you have any doubts, you can raise a doubt session also. And we keep posting all the important updates that is related to your NEET PG exam. So you can simply follow this channel to be updated with all the important things happening for NEET PG. So this is my code, as I told you, is very simple. It is KavitaS10. So once you put this code, you get instant discounts and great offers on your subscription. So please, whenever you go to take a subscription, please put down this code and you would get all the offers that is possible. And for all of those who are still thinking, guys, please at least join a plus subscription. It is going to benefit you very, very nicely for your preparation. So thank you all of you for listening so patiently. Please like, share and subscribe the channel so that you get notified about all the important classes that is happening and you prepare very nicely for your exam. So we'll meet up again tomorrow, same time at 6 p.m. with the fifth and the last part of pediatric cardiology that deals with the acquired heart diseases. So we'll be discussing about Kawasaki disease, cardiomyopathies, acute rheumatic fever, and a little bit about myocarditis and your infective endocarditis. So these are the leftover topics from cardiology. So we would finish cardiology all in 5 different sessions by tomorrow. And then you can revise it. Take ample time to understand the topic. You can do your own MCQs from any of the MCQ book. And you can also attempt my quiz on 18th of August at 6 p.m. So thank you for listening so patiently. All the best to all of you. Good luck. Study well. Stay confident.